It's the LSU Tigers against the Arizona Wildcats, and welcome again to another evening of Sunday Sports Final here on Channel 9. This is Tim Brando, and what a big ball game we've got coming up for you. Unheralded Arizona Wildcat team coming in to take on the LSU Tigers in a game that I think you'll find early on is a lot more than many of the LSU fans perhaps had expected. The Tigers come into this game looking for their second win in as many weeks at home. Bill Einsparker going for his first win against a Pac-10 school. Arizona, on the other hand, a team with a 2-1 record coming into the game, but that record a bit deceptive. They lost to Fresno State, their only loss in their home opener about 3 weeks ago, and they lost on a fluke play. Arizona is a team that does not give up a lot of yards rushing. It might be tough for Gary James and Dalton Hilliard early on as you watch some of this action. So we'll be back with you at halftime. We'll have a complete wrap-up of the weekend sports, all of the big games in college football as well as the pros and at the high school level as well. All of that coming your way at halftime of tonight's game. Right now, let's take you to Tiger Stadium and our announcers for this ball game, John Ferguson, along with Bert Jones and Doug Morrow. Gentlemen.
And here is a look at the crowd, which has really come to the game to watch exciting football in big numbers. And the presence of the sunshine in the late afternoon after the rain showers has really helped the crowd. And here's a look from the end zone. And there's the LSU Tiger team right to the left, ready to burst onto the field here. And Bert Jones and Doug Morrow will tell you this is one of the most exciting times in a football player's life at LSU. Here come the Tigers.
And there are a lot of nervous stomachs out there, John. I can tell you from coming through the underneath those goalposts many years ago, it was an awful lot of fun, but it was also a very anxious moment coming on the field. Isn't that right, Doug?
I tell you, you know, these guys have got to be happy with the way the day has developed. Earlier, it looked like the game was going to be one greatly affected by the weather condition, but it's cleared up in the last hour or so. It started to get a little bit cooler. The field is basically dry, and I think we're really going to see a great football game because there are two wide-open offensive teams.
And, Doug, it looks like the only place that it possibly may be wet as we see the toss of the coin is it on the side of the field.
Arizona has won the toss. You just saw the weather conditions, 77 degrees, east wind 10. And Arizona in the white tonight will be starting the game with the football. The Tigers in the purple and gold will be kicking off and defending the south end. What a big show this always is.
every game in Tiger Stadium, John, is a show in itself. But this one particularly, LSU and Arizona, is not the every year contest. Arizona is a team that people here don't know a great deal about, except it's coached by Larry Smith, who used to coach at Tulane, so there's some continuity there. It is a team that plays wide-open offensive football and has very many exciting players. And I think the fans here, after last week's rout of Wichita State, really are looking forward to a contest that is well played and a lot of hard hitting, a lot of exciting football.
Officials are referee Dick Burleson, umpire Ron Blum of the Pac-10, linesman George Morris, line judge Fred Gallagher, Al Granning is the field judge, Don Dorkowski, back judge out of the Pac-10, and Louis Richard is the electric clock operator. The other officials are from the SEC and some of the SEC's best. Mr. Burleson, Dick Burleson, is the referee. The Arizona Wildcats have won two games and lost one. The loss was to Fresno State. In this section of the country, Fresno State would be considered a minor opponent. LSU has tied Florida, one of the strongest teams in the country, and has beaten Wichita State. That's Matt DeFrank, number three, to kick off.
Matt's a freshman out of Florida also. I remember talking to him when he was trying to come up, decide where he was going to go, and then he's turned into a real fine kicker.
Down deep we have Hardy, and we also have Vance Johnson. The kickoff is going to the end zone and will not be run out.
And John, with the new rule change, that's a perfect kick because no longer can you kick it out of the end zone because then it comes out to the 30-yard line, and they've schooled Matt on that specifically, so he tries to keep it deep in the end zone yet not kicking it through the end zone, which takes a lot of talent to do.
And here's the offensive line for Arizona. It's a big line. Fox is 240. Collins is 245. The tackles are 260 and 280. Arizona first and 10, and the game is on at Tiger Stadium. I formation, and there goes Adams with Hobley. A 5-yard gain, and it's going to be second and five.
Adams demonstrated some running ability there. It was a pitch to the left. LSU had it stopped pretty well at the line of scrimmage there. The Tiger defense all along the right side had the play stopped. Adams dipped inside and stepped out around. Hobley had to come over from the secondary and make the tackle. And he's a man LSU will count on very heavily this evening.
Second and five play. Johnson to the 29. Wrapped up by Sean Burks and Tommy Kleff, number 97.
John, you'll notice
Gaston also in on the contact.
John, you'll notice that they bring in these offensive backs back and forth. There was Johnson. The play before was Adams. They send the play in from the sidelines all the way from the press box. They send in a lot of formation variation. And because of it, it's real tough for a defense to get set on them. They might have to make some substitutions that they really don't have time to do.
17 out of 55 and third down conversions this year. Here's the third down one play. Short side of the field to the Wildcats left. Nothing, just beginning play, and that's the tight end in motion. And here is a trap behind the line, and the Tigers penetrate. But that's John Henry Thomas in the middle to make first contact, and Arizona faces a fourth and one. That could be a key play in the game.
Certainly could. Arizona's first drive, Henry Thomas breaks through the middle of the line of scrimmage. Here you can see Adams getting the ball, and Henry Thomas made great penetration, but he wasn't the only one. The entire defensive front came through, made a great defensive play to stop him for the fourth down.
Jefferson is deep, and Troy Lawton, with about a 38-yard average, is back to punt. No rush of him. Good kick. My, a good kick. And Jefferson has it at the 20. Here he comes. The line is formed for him, but he's not going to get to the wall. Short of the 25, a 49-yard kick is returned about 4 yards.
And, John, that run back almost was more impressive than you thought because he had the wall formed. He was just a little late getting behind it, as you see the offensive for the LSU Tigers come up on the screen. He had a lot of running room. He just had one man to get outside.
And Don Beans came down there and fought off a block and really, as you said, made an exceptional play to stop the long run back.
Wickersham and company rolling left. Wickersham to throw. Here it is. Blocked. And blocked by Steve Boatway, outstanding linebacker who has 25 tackles to his credit. And Wickersham just didn't float the ball enough. And, Bert, that's a tough pass to throw in that kind of condition and still get feel on the ball.
It is. It's the first play coming out of the chute, as they say. And the key to that play was not necessarily he was trying to get it to the back, but you saw a rotation up on Eric Martin, and because of that, it took double coverage on him, and he had to go to the secondary receiver.
Dalton Hilliard to the left. The Tigers go to the short side to the 32-yard line. And this tackle is made by Lamont Hundley. Up to the 32-yard line.
Watch Dalton's quickness on the outside here. Avoids a man there, runs up yard. He picks up 7 yards when it was all on his own. Just a quick pitch around the defensive end and turn it up. And there you see his speed and quickness around the outside.
He had over 200 yards last week, and he and Gary James are a fearsome twosome. Third down and three from the 32. Quick shot, and that's complete to James. First down, midfield. He had a chance to go all the way. And that's Alan Durden. After a 20-yard gain, actually 19, and it's first down at 10 yards to go for the Tigers.
And here you see Gary James. It's a playoff of the first play of the game where they saw him roll up on Eric Martin. They comes up with a play-action fake away and gives Gary James an opportunity to catch a seam in the zone, and Jeff hit him just right.
First and 10 and a draw, and that is going to be Hilliard crawling to the 45. Durden, by the way, and this is Byron Evans making the first contact here, but Alan Durden, the free safety for the Arizona Wildcats' father, is one of the coaches, assistant coaches, with the San Diego Chargers. And while we're at that, offensive lineman Collins, Guy Collins, number 53, is the son of Gary Collins, the MC of TV's Our Magazine program and the MC of the Miss America pageant a week ago. Second down and 6 yards to go at the Arizona 45. Tigers nothing and Arizona nothing, and here comes James at the 40. Evans again, and Greg Turner on the tackle for Arizona.
and just short of the first down. It'll be interesting to see whether the Tigers just try to power it right here. They're in a position on the field where they pretty much could try anything they wanted, because if they decide to go for it on fourth down, they can certainly do that. Coach Arnsberger indicated by his play calling in the Florida game that he's not afraid to try something that's a little unusual, and that puts the other team on the defensive all the time.
Curtis is in at left end. That's tight end, and so we have two tight ends for LSU, eight-man defensive line, and here comes James. He has the first down. He evaded a tackle behind the line. Lamont Hundley, as he makes the tackle, Greg Turner was the man who was maneuvered out of position by James at first and 10 LSU.
Here's a fine run by Gary James, knowing he only needed 1 yard on that. He was supposed to go off the left tackle, but everything was clogged up there. He just bounced it outside and showed his good athletic ability and got it around the corner for the first.
Another first down. LSU had 29 of them last week against Wichita State Shocker team. And here is that same formation. Run to the left with a pass to Hilliard. Hit down. Downfield tackle by Turner. And so it's going to be another first down, about a 12-yard advance. Byron Evans also in on the contact.
LSU's run a lot of misdirection, running plays, and they're doing basically the same thing in the passing game. They're running counter actions, this time on the to the weak side of the field. They bring Hilliard out into the flat, just dump the ball to him for a nice first down.
Remaining back in this formation is Hilliard, the double wing with Fontenot, the slot man, left, and Hilliard goes to the slot side, out of bounds at the 25. Ridden out by two or three fellas, including Boomer Gibson, number 44. And that's a short gain of about 2 yards. They say to the 24-yard line, it'll be second down and 8 yards to go. It appears to me, Ben, that the LSU team is really ready to play in this game.
They look like it so far, John, and it's very interesting, don't you think, Bert, that they've come out and just stuck it to Arizona in a lot of different ways on this first drive.
Well, I think that's indicative of their coaching staff and Bill Armstrong.
That's James in motion going toward Fontenot. They're together out there, and a quick shot is coming up. It is overthrown purposely. Fontenot was not quite open, and Wickersham held the ball a long time, waiting for him to work into the clear, and he just tossed it away. Tough decision to make.
Well, it was a good decision to make, throw it away there. That's one of those plays that you work on all week, and you say, well, if we send this man in motion, they might send a linebacker out on him, and then he won't cover him, and then we'll have the man open in the middle. It always works great in practice, but sometimes when you get in the ball game in the situation, it just doesn't seem to work in that way. And that time, Jeff made the wise decision throwing the ball away.
Third down, 8 yards to go at the Arizona 24. The Tigers may be in field goal range. Here's the third down play. Wickersham is going to be hit behind the line and is by Hundley. At the 29, he loses 5. Also in on the contact is John Barthol. Isn't she pretty?
She sure is. And that's something LSU's got to be prepared for. Arizona had 22 sacks coming into this game, as opposed to 25 entire last season, and they were ranked fourth nationally in total defense last season. So that'll tell you a little bit about the aggressiveness of their defensive front.
Here is a 45-yard field goal try by Juan Betanzas. The kick is on its way. It is good. Timeout of the game at Tiger Stadium. The LSU Tigers are now ahead of Arizona to score 3-0.
Your 98 WAFB Loves Me rear window sticker means cash. Put a 98 WAFB Loves Me rear window sticker on your car or truck and listen to FM 98. When you hear us call your license tag number, call us and we'll pay your next car note or give you $200 in cash. And you might even win a brand new 1985 Toyota Corolla sedan. Remember, the longer you listen, the better your chance to win. Be a winner. Stick with 98 WAFB Radio.
It's easy to talk about the problems we face in Baton Rouge. What really matters, however, is results. As Metro Councilman for District 11, Ben Peabody has listened to our problems and then worked to solve them. He has fought to protect our neighborhoods from commercial intrusion, to help improve our streets and drainage, to build a stronger ethics commission, and led the fight to get the drunk driver off our streets. While others talk about what they're going to do, Ben Peabody is getting the job done for all of us. Ben Peabody, Metro Councilman, District 11.
Will kick off again as the Tigers have jumped out to a 3-0 lead. And Down deep are number 25, Vance Johnson, real cat running back, and the other man is Eugene Hardy, just to the left of him. 47 yards, 11 plays, 3.5 minutes of time consumed, and Batantis responds with a 45-yard field goal. Incidentally, field goal kicker for the Arizona team has kicked a 53-yarder this year, and Batantis has missed only one out of eight. Frank kicks another one just to the right place. That's Johnson. Somebody's without a headgear out of there, and he is up to the 20-yard line.
And if you ever let Vance Johnson in the open by himself, he can go a long way. He can broad jump over 26 feet. He's a world-class jumper, isn't he, Doug?
He doesn't have to run very far.
He can just jump three times, and he'll be at the other end of the field.
In fact, I was surprised on the third down play last series. They didn't put him in there. Just give it to him, let him jump as far as he could, and see if they'd make the first.
DeWitt, reserve quarterback, made the tackle there, along with Garland Jean-Baptiste from St. Martinville. First down, 10 yards to go for the Arizona Wildcats, coached by Larry Smith. With Tulane, he came here twice and went away empty-handed both times. One remaining back here, that's Adams, and he gets the pitch out. Little man, 5'6", is found at the 21 by Carl Wilson. And that's a pretty good threesome in the front there, men. Tommy Clapp, number 97. On the left, and Henry Thomas in the middle, and Carl Wilson on the right. They weigh 260, 255, and 250, and they seem to be pretty agile. Here comes the second down and nine situation right now.
And you know, being an interesting thing to watch the entire game will be, I think you have a finesse offense versus a finesse defense, and it's really going to be fun to watch the coaches try to play chess with each other.
John Horton, a split end, is wide out to the right. They're going to throw to him if they can. They do. Incomplete. High over his head and almost picked off by Jeffrey Dale, number four. The Tigers are blessed with a couple of deep safety threats always. Number four, Jeffrey Dale from Winfield, and number 29, Lippert Hopley from Bird High School of Freeport. Each is a senior. So far, Arizona has 10 yards total offense, LSU 47 and 3 points. It's 3-0 Tigers. First quarter.
Shotgun.
We've been told to expect the shotgun, and Jenkins, the quarterback, rifles one out here that's going to be incomplete. If caught by Jay Dobbins, who's caught 13 into this game, it was dropped outside or caught out of the field of play. Let's check it.
And here you're going to see the snap. Jenkins gets the ball out there, and Dobbins is in a position to make the catch. He was a little short of the first down anyway, but Jeffrey Dale came up and made sure that he wasn't going to catch the ball.
And so did Kevin Guidry, left cornerback. Here's a punt again coming up with Troy Lawton from the 21-yard line. Norman Jefferson is up the field, and here's the kick. Another good one. Boy, he can really pop that ball at the 29. Here comes Norman to the 40. He can go. He's at the 50. He's at the 40-yard line. And is dumped by the kicker. 33-yard run back of Lawton's 52-yard kick. And we have a Tiger down, been shaken up back at the 40-yard line. And that is Ricky Chapman, but he apparently will be all right. Let's check Jefferson as he broke into the clear.
This time Norman decided that he was going to try to go all the way around the corner. He saw the wall after he got tackled on the last play, and this time he was going to get to it as quick as he could. Had it not been for that kicker, it would have been a touchdown, John.
That's correct. And here's Ricky Chapman, also from Winfield. And the senior coming off the field, and there's Norman Jefferson, sophomore, number 12. Jeff Wickersham trots into the huddle, number 5, Merritt Island, Florida. And he's coming on to move the Tigers now from the Arizona 40-yard line. First down and 10 to go for the purple and gold. Remaining back is Hilliard. Fake to him, and Wickersham throws now. It's incomplete. He had two men in the clear and unfortunately overthrows Eric Martin. The other man in the clear was Gary James, but Wickersham just had too much mustard on the ball.
He did. He just overthrew it a little bit. It might be a little wet ball, but whatever the case, it's really his first pass downfield. And there you saw an experienced defensive back. He knew the ball was out of play, but Durden came on over and gave Eric Martin a fine hit on the sidelines because it was a free shot. He was up in the air and he got a chance.
Second and 10. Little screen out here. Eric Martin is down to the 27-yard line and downed by Steve Bodway. 13 yards on that scamper.
This is a good play for a couple of reasons. Number one, Eric Martin picks up almost 12 or 13 yards. But secondly, and almost as important, is you had Jeff Wickersham badly overthrow a couple of passes earlier today, and this gives him a good pass completion for good yardage and enables him to kind of get a feel on the ball game again.
First down, Dalton Hilliard is spilled coming around to the left side and by Greg Turner, number 40. Nope, that's going to be number 35, Brent Wood. And also number 89 is coming out of there, and that's going to be Lamont Huntley in on the contact, and Hilliard comes off for a rest. The position of the ball is the Arizona Wildcat 26-yard line. It's going to be second down and 9. Martin, great catch at the 13. Up in the air, and he's hit there by Alan Durden, but too late. Martin already had the ball. It's another 13-yard gain. And first down for the LSU Tigers at the Arizona 13.
Here's a play, John, where Eric Martin just got in between the two defenders. They've been double covering Eric Martin every play, so they're running plays that are designed to throw in between them because there's only one man on him at a time, short and deep, and they're catching him right in between the seam of the zone.
That's the 11th catch of the year for Eric Martin, premier receiver in the SEC, in motion James, and a quick shot out there, drops the ball. James is incomplete with it at the 10.
You can't go at all without the ball.
Lyndon Brown was the defender, and you're so right.
Lyndon was supposed to be the defender, John. I don't think there was any way he could have kept up with Gary James. And Gary, who was a receiver in high school before being switched to running back as a senior, certainly is a type of person that normally would catch that pass. He had a sure touchdown if he had held on to it.
Second and 10 inside the Arizona 15. LSU ahead 3-0. Wickersham again over the head of the receiver, Gary James.
Same time, same station, John, same play. This time the throw was a little better covered on that one play.
And McGee was in touchdown territory in the moonlight. Third down.
This is a pretty critical play because they didn't go in and score the last time. This time they have a third down for the score.
Roger McGee is wide to the right side. That's Gary James in motion behind Wickersham, who will throw. Here's a man open. He intercepts at the 5. Here comes Durden to the 30, to the 40, to the 50. He may go all the way. He will. It'll be a 95-yard interception return for a touchdown, and Arizona bolts out into the lead. Alan Durden runs up the near sidelines, and we want to watch that one again. It's a 95-yard interception return, longest ever against the LSU Tigers. And Arizona is ahead.
On this play, Jeff, I guarantee you wishes he had it back. He had the man open. He just overthrew him there. And Durden, being the experienced player that he is, coming from an experienced family in the football business, knows what to do with it.
And I tell you, this would be real sad things. It would be 6 points LSU the other way if Earl Curtis had had a chance to catch the ball. This way, it's 6 for the Wildcats.
Zendejas kicks the point after, and we have a timeout in the game with 6:50 to go in the first quarter. Here's your score, Arizona 7, LSU 3.
Zenith Space Command. More features add up to greater viewing pleasure and enjoyment. And now you can have double the convenience, because right now, with the purchase of any Zenith portable or console Space Command model, we'll send you a second remote control for free. This won't last long, so hurry. A second Space Command unit for free. From Zenith, always the value leader.
For the finest in saving service and selection, the place to shop is LaMonica's TV. 2 locations.
Make no mistake about it. Narcotics is one of the greatest problems in America today. Because Baton Rouge is a major port, we're particularly vulnerable to filthy narcotics trafficking. As district attorney, my job is to convict the pushers, and this I've done. My conviction rate is 92%. Am I satisfied? No, and I never will be. Not until we've got the poison off our streets and the pushers behind bars where they belong. Please help me continue to do this job for all of us.
District Attorney O.C. Brown.
Gives Alan Durden credit for 96 yards on the interception return. And Zendejas has kicked the point after. It is a 7-3 game. LSU has all of the advantage in the stats, and Arizona has a 4-point lead. Down deep for Gary James and Herman Fontenot to receive Zendejas' kickoff. Herman Fontenot from the goal line. He's wrestled down at about the 22-yard line by Bill Bradley, who's made two special team tackles in this game so far. He's a senior from Phoenix. LSU, first down at Tenduco at the Tigers' 22-yard line. And now, gentlemen, what do the Tigers do? Down by 7-3, and I think probably that 96-yard interception return is the longest in Arizona history.
I haven't seen many longer.
And here's a run up the middle that's going nowhere.
As all drives are, all possessions of the ball are critical, but this one is a little more critical because Jeff Wickersham has had some good passes thrown and some bad passes thrown. Now is when the coaches need to get back and give him a pass, give him a confident reception, and let him go on and do his business like he can.
Hilliard was stopped by Jim Birmingham at nose guard. Here's a pass that's too low, intended for Herman Fontenot. We have a flag on the play.
Well, LSU's had a free play that time because Arizona was offside. But still, I think, Burke, the way the play developed points out what could really be a problem. And Jeff Wickersham's just not throwing the ball well. You saw on a 10-yard throw there, he completely missed his receiver.
He did, and the reason he missed his receiver is because he's trying to catch the ball for the receiver. Here you'll see a lot of penalties out there.
Tigers are averaging almost 68 yards a game in penalties, and Arizona a little more than that. Offside, says Dick Burleson, and so it's going to be second down and 5. The Tigers have the ball at the LSU 27. A lot of times in professional football, I know on a down like this, you've thrown the ball as far as you can throw it. Isn't that true, Bert?
Without question. Now, Jeff is going to start throwing the ball firm and hard again just because that's what he does best. He's got to get the field back. He's trying to catch the ball for the receiver with the throws. As you see, a little misdirection play up the middle with Gary James running.
And Byron Evans, number 48, makes the stop. They say at the 28-yard line. And so it's going to be third down and about 4 yards to go for a first down. 7-3 Arizona. On Alan Durden, he's the free safety for the Wildcats. 96-yard interception return up the near sidelines for a touchdown for the Wildcats. And the Wildcats are holding firm with their reputation as a big play team this year. Wickersham to throw. Reception. James has it out of bounds. First down at the 35. 7 yards. And Don Behan, number 29, is there. And Greg Turner is also in the area of the reception.
There you see Jeff just winding up, throwing it the way he knows how, putting a lot of power behind the throw. One of the things he does best, he's got a very gifted, strong arm, Doug, and when he reaches back and throws it, he can throw it as well as anyone. It's when he throws that little touch and trying to catch the ball for him that he gets in trouble sometimes.
I don't know, wide to the right and Martin to the left, and here's a quick shot attempted, and it's not going to get away. Val Pacheco's, number 50, nose guard, makes the tackle inside the 30, and it's a -6 on that sack behind the line.
And here you see Pacheco's coming right up the middle. He just made a great defensive play. Wickersham was going to throw the ball immediately. Receiver wasn't open, pulled it down, and it was just too late. Pacheco's had him sacked.
Joe Drake is back in there. He's running at jersey number 79 and weighs 318 pounds. You see him right in the middle of the line. And here is Gary James to the outside. Slips at the 30. Third down and 15 coming up. Not really hit. He was trying to make a turn, but tried to get away from Jordan Bunch. He loses his footing.
And that brings back up the point, John, of these playing conditions that you're looking at. You know, the ball, when they put it down on the ground, typically gets wet in one place. And if you hold the seams of the football like most quarterbacks do, it seems to always hit you right where your thumb lands on the bottom of the football, and it makes it slick and makes it hard to throw the ball hard.
Back to spread, and Wickersham has a lot of time. Incomplete. Intended for Herman Fontenot, and a good defensive play by strong safety Lyndon Brown. He made a legal hit. He waited until the time was just right, and so even though a few boos came through the air, they were not justified because the contact was entirely legal. A punt with Clay Parker And up the field for the men from Arizona will be David Adams, number two. He's standing at the Wildcat 30. There he is. Stands only 5'6". He's the leading ball carrier, punt returner, and all of that. They rush and almost gets the kick blocked. And so out of bounds it's going. Not a good kick. Maybe partially blocked out there. We'll check the replay to see if we can determine that. And out of bounds at the 50-yard line, a 20-yard Clay Parker punt under the force of a huge Wildcat rush.
John, that's one of the things Larry Smith's teams do, and they do it consistently. Here you see the snap is a little high, but Clay Parker, when he gets that high snap against this team giving him the rush, has got to hurry to get it off. Here he didn't hurry till the last second, and then he got a bad kick off the side of his foot.
So Jenkins, Alfred Jenkins, number one, the quarterback, sets the Wildcats again and will go to the air. Rolling to the right. Overthrows his receiver, Gary Perry, who caught seven into this game. Number 83, tight end. Good Tiger coverage on that.
Jenkins showed that he had a good arm there, but it would have taken just an average arm to get it to that receiver.
Jenkins, to this game, Bert, had completed 33 out of 65 and had thrown for three touchdowns. Wickersham, by contrast, has thrown for two touchdowns, 35 out of 59 attempts complete. Second and 10, shotgun again with Jenkins, the tailback. Double wing in front of him, and that's normal for the shotgun. And here's Jenkins with a lot of time. And that's complete to the 39-yard line. And a tackle first by Burks. And here is John Horton, the split end, who's getting credit for the catch. And it's first down at the LSU 39-yard line. Tigers will have to be very careful at this point of the field. Down 4 points after the interception return. I think it's only fair to say at this point that some of the starch is out of the Tigers' jerseys right for the moment.
Without question, they're losing momentum by the down.
Throwback plunge up the middle. That first down, by the way, is the first one of the game for Arizona. 3:25 to go in the first quarter. Carl Wilson makes the stop here. And Phil Freeman, number 41, the fullback, doesn't go very far. He stopped, they say, at the 35-yard line. It'll be second down, along six to go. Arizona fairly deep in Tiger territory and ahead by four in the first quarter. Over the ball, Nils Fox, senior from Portland. Looking at Henry Thomas, number 96, right on him. They have a good battle going there, and that's David Adams to the left. Trying to get under people, and he does to a considerable degree. Henry Thomas is out there to make the stop with a lot of help, and so they're going to put the ball at the 32-yard line. That'll bring up third down and about three.
And LSU with another big down. Bert, you mentioned last series for LSU offensively that it was a big series. This, up to this point, I think, is the most important down of this football game.
Single coverage on Jay Dobbins, premier receiver, wide right. Third down and three at the LSU 32. Big down. Jenkins being chased, throwing for Dobbins, and the pass is going way beyond the field. Incomplete. Fourth down. Kevin Guidry covering. Zendejas, number 13, has kicked one this year, 54 yards long, and he has plenty of leg for this, and let's see if they send him in. He's 6 out of 7 from the field this year, and he will try a 49-yarder.
And John, this is Max Zendejas. His brother Luis Zendejas was the kicker for Arizona State. Max, of course, the kicker for Arizona, and both exceptional place kickers. This Max Zendejas, 20 of 25 last year, which is a tremendous average, did not miss inside the 40-yard line.
Timeout. And so Arizona has something wrong out there. Not enough people on the field, perhaps. Timeout in the game. The score is Arizona 7, LSU 3.
Now cover a 10 by 12 foot area with lovely no-wax Armstrong Sundial Solarian for only $188. At Elroy Coke Service Incorporated, Donaldsonville.
V.J. Gentiloni Jr., an honest leader with proven mature experience, a full-time councilman for District 12. V.J. knows city parish government. As a department head, he worked with our council members, gaining unique insight into our government and its workings. V.J. also knows we need a full-time councilman. He will work for us. He will bring his mobile office to our neighborhoods each week. He will be that full-time councilman we need. District 12 needs V.J. Gentiloni Jr., a full-time councilman working for us.
Rendejas kicks the 49-yarder with 2:10 to go in the first quarter, and Arizona stretches a lead to 10-3. And Rendejas shows why Larry Smith, the Arizona coach, leans heavily on him and has great confidence in him. So Arizona now leads 10-3. And the Tigers, since the interception returned by Durden for a touchdown, have not had the vinegar with which they started the game.
John, it's interesting how small things change the course of a game. You recall Gary James dropped pass on that same drive shortly before the interception. Had it been caught, he had clear sailing 10 yards into the end zone for a touchdown. LSU would have been clearly up and was in dominant control of the game at that point. As it is, of course, Arizona turned the tables completely with the interception. It put them ahead. And though they're down statistically in all other statistics than the score, the only one that they put up on that board is the score. And in addition to that right now, as you mentioned a moment ago, they've got the momentum. The Tigers are struggling right now.
They are really struggling. And they haven't put anything together from the interception on down. They haven't done anything. They let Arizona move the ball a little bit on offense, enable them to get down and kick a field goal, and they haven't moved the ball on offense.
Six plays, 18 yards, 2 minutes. All that culminated in a 49-yard field goal by Rendejas, who's kicking off now for the Wildcats. James and Fontenot are down deep, and that ball is going to go beyond James, and it will be a touchback, and the Tigers will put the ball in play at their 20. Providing, that is, there's no penalty on the kickoff, and there seems to be none, and so the Tigers, in the purple shirts, will have the football again. There goes Jeff Wickersham. But Bill Armstrong's team is working now from a 7-point deficit and being urged on vociferously by the people in the stands here at Tiger Stadium. Play action fake and a pass to Martin is complete for a first down up to the 35-yard line.
I think Jeff
Huntley makes contact with Alan Durden to stop the play at that point.
I think Jeff Wickersham is thinking the same thing that I was. Let's get a good throw in. Let's start firing that ball instead of just sitting back and kind of lobbing it out there and trying to help catch him. There you see Bill Armstrong on the sideline talking, trying to figure out what it'll take.
He has Marlboro and DeWitt talking to him there in a close conversation. And here goes a run up the middle over right guard by Dalton Hilliard for short yardage, about three. Really stacked up in there. David Wood, one of the numbers we see. And the last man to get up will be Lamont Huntley. Joe Drake is also there. So Huntley weighs 237 and Drake weighs 318. So no wonder Hilliard, who weighs 187, goes down. Second and seven. The Tigers are at their 38 and down by 10-3 late in the first quarter. That's Hilliard. Good move. He's down at about the 43. Drake, who has unusual agility for a big man, has help from Henley, linebacker. So it's going to be third down and two.
And LSU is almost having very good plays. That play was open in the middle. John Harrell was pulling from left tackle and didn't quite get turned upfield. And had he done that, Hilliard would have not had the trip on him and do his spinning and would have gotten past the first down.
James in motion with Hilliard, the remaining setback, and a quick shot out to Hilliard. So that's James. First down at the 46-yard line. Good catch. Gordon Bunch hits him as he makes the reception. This time James hangs on. It's first and 10.
I tell you, though, he paid for it. James in motion, right to left, out into the left flat. And as soon as he made the reception, Bunch came up and made a good lick on it. I guess Arizona would be more than happy. They're measuring for the first down, so the official saying it's not a first, clearly. It looks pretty clear from up here, but of course the official's the one that makes the final ruling.
First down by three quarters of a yard. Fresno State and beaten in Pac-10 play California and Oregon State. Good run up to just shy of the 45-yard line in Arizona territory. Drake and Hundley make the stop. And the ball carrier for LSU is one of the fine ones of this league. And that's Dalton Gibson. Quarter here at Tiger Stadium. The score is Arizona 10, LSU 3.
For only 3 years, but already a new certainty about our future. Yes, a future demanding aggressive and intelligent leadership. Pat Screen. His innovative ideas are protecting our lives, like EMS, Emergency Medical Service. Pat Screen's vision is rebuilding our past and creating new jobs for the future. Catfish Town and Riverfront redevelopment. His progressive promotion of our community has won for Baton Rouge the 1985 National Sports Festival, America's Olympics. Pat Screen has shaped new initiatives against crime. New initiatives that have resulted in the first drop in our crime rate in a decade. And his tough approach has demanded more from our limited resources and has meant improved basic services for all of us. We are certain, but should we be? Yes, we can be. When you think about our future, Pat Screen makes sense today.
Down as they get back to play just a shade early. Steve Bodway, number 47, rides it down. And we'd like to show you the power with which LSU is operating right now to give Dalton Hilliard the time and the element with which to move.
John, you'll see here what a lot of teams haven't been able to do against Arizona is they're beginning to dominate the ground game, something that I think they're going to have to do in order to establish supremacy on the field. Their offensive line is dominating the defensive line, and they're just going right at them right now.
Hilliard for short yardage on first down from the Arizona 39. The check is number 50, first to make contact, and also we have John Barthold, number 99, in on that. LSU had the ball almost 10 minutes in the first quarter, and still Arizona had a 7-point lead. Here's Hilliard to see what he's done so far.
And just a young man with all those stats.
And Arizona, going back to your remark about the ground game, has been allowing only 49 yards rushing per game. And this is Gary James. Open field, maybe. He gets to the sideline fast. He's out of bounds at the 30. 1 yard short of the first down. He was just chased off the field by Lyndon Brown and others. Gary James, 169 yards up to this time.
Right here, you'll see Gary James able to get outside. The reason they're able to get outside, John and Doug, so far Arizona has been playing a two-kick zone where they roll up both cornerbacks, which does takes the linebackers out of containment and makes the cornerbacks the contained men, and they're able to get outside as long as they get a play on the
Wickersham, and that's complete for the first down to Gary James. Third down and one, and the Tigers go to the air. How about that? Brian Evans makes the tackle as James catches the ball right here.
Wickersham is looking downhill. James came down right inside of the sideline. The official said he was right inside of the sideline and gave him the first down. Could have gone either way, perhaps.
I think he decided he was at a tennis match where the line counts.
First down at the 26. Wickersham on a draw to James. Nothing for him. Huntley is number 98 right there. James and Hilliard, no doubt, would represent one of the top 1-2 punches in collegiate football this year. And Wickersham, especially in the SEC, would have to be rated as one of the top quarterbacks. As this year in the SEC, I think that 8 out of the 10 teams are looking for a quarterback to take over the team. What about Georgia today, beating Clemson by 3 on a 60-yard Butler field goal? That was something. The Tigers now are down by 7 as Wickersham throws quickly. That's Herman Fontenot running out of bounds at the 21. 5 25 yards, and Alan Durden runs him off the field.
It was a good play on Jeff's part on that play right there, as he had Trent Wood breathing down his neck, and all he did was just see him come, dodge a little bit, throw the ball, and take his lick.
Third down and 5 at the Arizona 21-yard line. Rocky McGee is wide left. Eric Martin is back in and is set to the right. Wickersham throwing. Almost intercepted. That would have gone for 6 points also had it been held by number 35, Brent Wood. So Wickersham is throwing under those receivers, running to the out patterns there, and that's a dangerous type of pattern to throw.
Well, that question is Brent Wood again all over the field. That time, Jeff just threw a bad pass. He's been throwing an awful lot of good ones, but he's thrown a few bad ones. That was another bad one right there. Had he gotten it out front, we possibly could have had a first down, but luckily. And, John, you think that it would have been 6? You don't think Jeff could have made the tackle?
He would have been gone, Gosman. Here is a 38-yard field goal try by the Tigers, Juan Betances. The kick is on the way. It is good. Timeout of the game, a 13-01 to play in the first half. The score now, Arizona 10, LSU 6.
No mistake about it. Narcotics is one of the greatest problems in America today. Because Baton Rouge is a major port, we're particularly vulnerable to filthy narcotics trafficking. As district attorney, my job is to convict the pushers, and this I've done. My conviction rate is 92%. Am I satisfied? No, and I never will be. Not until we've got the poison off our streets and the pushers behind bars where they belong. Please help me continue to do this job for all of us.
District Attorney O.C. Brown.
Your 98 WAF.
Matt DeFrank is down deep for 22 Eugene Hardy and 25 Vance Johnson for Arizona. Dick Burleson says, let's do it. And here's Matt DeFrank. Out of the end zone, out to the 25, the 30, out of bounds at the Arizona 37-yard line. Vance Johnson just got the slightest bit of daylight, and he goes scurrying up the field to the 37-yard line. It's a fine return.
That's all Vance needs. We mentioned earlier, 1982 NCAA long jump champion, and all he needs is that little seam. Here he takes a dip to the inside, makes a nice break through the seam, and he was almost gone all the way. A good game-saving tackle.
Alfred Jenkins, number one at quarterback again, has two receivers wide left, goes back two steps, and he's throwing a beat on somebody. He incomplete. This is the ball up the field. And that is number 86, John Horton, who was in position, but the pass in front of Guidry of LSU was just a little bit low.
John, that was a fine play by Kevin Guidry there, freshman, coming back. They're playing the zone, but he had a man hooking up right in front of him. There you see LSU with 139 total yards as opposed to Arizona's 28, but they're behind in the score.
10-6, Arizona ahead of LSU. Second quarter, early in the period, and here's the Wildcat shotgun with Jenkins checking off a play, and he lets it go. Out of bounds, incomplete, and intended for Jay Dobbins, the flanker, number 82. In first down from this game, another great disparity. LSU has 10, Arizona has 1. That came just before Max Zendejas' field goal, which was 49 yards in length. Third down and 10. The Wildcats at their 37 and going from the shotgun again. Jenkins running around with the ball, wants to throw long. He's got one coming open. Horton out of bounds at the LSU 33-yard line. Guidry and Dale are the two Tiger defenders, but Jenkins was able to hold the ball long enough to get the completion.
This is a design play where Jenkins sets up in the pocket. He has his near side back stay in, block the end, which buys him time that enables the receiver from all the way across the field to get across after a man's cleared that zone to come underneath and make the reception for 30 yards.
First down, the Wildcats at the LSU 33. And here's Jenkins faking the pitch out and throws too high and intended for Dobbins. Guidry, number 27, the Tiger defender.
Now take
tell you, though they have only two first downs, John, they are leading in the score, and Arizona does a lot of things offensively that are exciting to the fans and that the defensive coaches don't really like to see, because all of them are designed to put someone in position to break it all the way for a touchdown. We really have a wide open offense. It's a great thing for a spectator, but that's the drive coaches crazy.
And that's the reason why so many of those plays being successful, that Arizona has a reputation of being a big play team. Jenkins complete. And that's Gary Parrish, the tight end. That's the 25, the 24. 9 yards. It appears not enough for a first down. Here's the replay of it. Jenkins again has good protection. And fires a good one, Bert. That was a nice pass.
Certainly was. That time he brought the ball down, he's had a tendency to throw high. That time he hit the receiver right on the numbers.
Jeffrey Dale was right there in time, but it's third down and one. And Arizona wants timeout with 11:58 to go in the half. Timeout of the game. The score is Arizona 10, LSU 6.
Where 98 WAFB loves me, rear window sticker means cash. Put a 98 WAFB loves me rear window sticker on your car or truck and listen to FM 98. When you hear us call your license tag number, call us, and we'll pay your next car note or give you $200 in cash. And you might even win a brand new 1985 Toyota Corolla sedan. Remember, the longer you listen, the better your chance to win. Be a winner. Stick with 98 WAFB Radio.
Back to play there, James and Rafton on the near side as Arizona has a possession down coming up. Third down, a yard to go at the LSU 24. Big down for both teams right here. Quarterback Sneak is going to pick up the necessary yardage, apparently. Down to the LSU 23. Jenkins just lumbered ahead behind the hard-charging forward wall of Arizona. Wilson, the last man to get up for the Tigers.
Jenkins can do a lot of things. He was the L.A. Player of the Year, I think, back in 1982. Isn't that right, Doug?
Pretty big area to be the player of the year, to be anything of the year. Redshirted a year at Arizona and has come on. John Connor, starting quarterback, hurt his knee in the first game, and Jenkins has really come on gangbusters the last couple of weeks.
Here's Alfred Jenkins, number one in the shotgun. He has Dobbins and Horton wide to the right side. First down at the LSU 23. And a handoff up the middle goes number 25, and that's going to be for the man from Arizona, Vance Johnson, who really can buff and go. He's down inside the 20 at the 18, hit by Greg Dubrock. Let's watch Johnson's long jump champion.
This is a play off of the shotgun that you don't see a whole lot anymore. It's kind of like an underneath Statue of Liberty play that we used to all do out on the playground. There you see Johnson with his excellent athletic ability, just spinning as Tony Dorsett does it quite a bit. And running up the middle, 5 yards.
Johnson almost made the Olympic team at the long jump this year. From the 18, that's David Adams, cutting back against the grain, and he's smothered at the 17. On a second down and 5. It'll be third down and 4. Toby Caston and Carl Wilson smack him down. The little man just couldn't get too far.
Well, John, though he was smothered, he still made a couple of yards. The Arizona line is getting movement in the LSU defensive line, and they're not able to get enough penetration to stop him in the backfield.
Third down and 4 at the LSU 17. Arizona is surely within Max and Dayhaus field goal range, but the Wildcats would like to get 6 if possible. Jenkins barks it out. The Horton in motion. Puff one time. He'll go. Knocked down.
Knocked that pass down, but you'd rather that middle guard to be in the quarterback space. He was stymied on the line of scrimmage and did the next best thing, raised his hand up and batted the ball down. But you saw the excellent offensive blocking that Arizona is getting, and they're giving Jenkins more than adequate time to throw the football.
A 33-yard field goal try straight away at the north end will be attempted by Max Lindehart. Almost automatic. He kicks it. It's good. Timeout of the game. 10:03 to go in the half. The score is now Arizona 13, LSU 6.
here comes the kickoff as we see.
The Dejas forward. And he kicks it beyond the end line. It'll be one that comes out to the 30. He just kicked that one too far.
That was a fine play on Gary James' part. That's heads-up football right there. He was standing relatively deep in the end zone, knew that he probably wasn't going to have a chance to run the ball out. Could have caught the football, but he elected to let it drop, and that gives him 10 more yards. As you see Pete Jenkins trying to pep up that defensive line, saying, let's go, gang.
And those guys are talking about trying to get some penetration against that Arizona offense and make some big plays to keep them back up the field, where Zendejas is too far away for the field goal.
Arizona leads 13-6. Pass is blocked and almost intercepted over there on the defensive right end by number 44, who is Boomer Gibson. And Wickersham is just really not with it right now.
And it looks, John, right now what, like Arizona pretty much knows what LSU is going to try to do, and I think it's become pretty obvious that they feel they're going to rely on the short passing game. It just has not been that successful, and Arizona has made, of course, the big play, the interception return for the touchdown, and has come pretty close on a couple of others, that being one.
The spread backs are Gary James and Rafton. Draw play with James to carry. Got that on his own, didn't he? Up to about the 34-yard line on second down and 10. Hit by Joe Drake.
And Joe, for a guy that weighs about 300 pounds, moves very well, but he does the one thing, Bert, you mentioned that the middle guard guy do, too short to play anywhere else and too big for anybody to move.
That's correct. All he has to do is clog up that middle, and he does a good job at that, doesn't he?
First down, a long six to go for the first down. LSU down by 7, and Wickersham is back to throw. And Mark just a yard shy of midfield for first down. 16 yards on this catch. And Wickersham goes to his number one receiver, Eric Martin. He's hit by Lyndon Brown. And let's look at this one. It's a well-executed play.
All the way from the setup, Jeff looks like a picture-perfect quarterback. There you see that ball, perfect tight spiral right down the field. He waited until he got in between a couple of linebackers so he could get the ball to him on the line. And Eric Martin, as he always seems to do, catches the ball.
You get the feeling that the Tigers could explode at any minute. Here is Wickersham to throw across pattern. Montano can't hold it. Greg Turner was the defender on the play, and harassing the passer back there was defensive right tackle John Barthol, number 99. Second down, 10. Rafton brings the playoff.
Arizona has not gotten a lot of pressure on Jeff Wickersham on the short passes, but anytime he goes back and tries to get the ball 12, 15 yards downfield, the time that it takes allows them to get to him and put pressure on him.
Pitch out to Hilliard, and here he goes. First down, stopped at the 33 by Byron Evans. And Lyndon Brown, just when Arizona was looking for the aerial thrust, here goes Dalton Hilliard.
Dalton Hilliard getting around the corner here. You'll see the cornerback is the force man once again, and that keeps that linebacker inside. And if you can keep the linebacker inside and away for those running backs, Dalton Hilliard and Gary James can get around almost any corner.
Credit to Mitch Andrews with a good block, and also Kevin Langford with a key block. First down. James.
It was good one.
31.
Let's try it again.
No, that's Sam Martin, number 23. Don Behan and Byron Evans. 1-2 on the tackle, numbers 29 and 48. At the 31-yard line. 13-6, Arizona over the Tigers of LSU. The Tigers have second down and about 7 yards to go. Martin stumbles and runs into Rafton out here trying to make a block for him. Lee Bodway was among all of those people there, and so it's not a very long game, but it's third down and about 2 to go for the LSU Tigers.
Not a bad idea, but Rafton supposed to block for him.
and he's supposed to block after we catch the ball.
After we catch the ball. I think the official forgot about his yellow flag.
Wide left of Montano and Martin, and here is Hilliard for the first down. We'll have to hurry. It's going to be close. Another big decision coming up as Greg Turner chases Hilliard off the field somewhere around the point at which
get the first down, but be credited to the Tigers.
I think it's going to be a little short, trying to get around the corner once again. This time they didn't get to seal off block on the linebacker. He got outside and forced the play to go a little wider than it needed to go in order to get the first.
That chain will come all the way across, and you'll have a chance to see it.
And John, this is an interesting thing because they have markers on both sides of the field, and it looked like Hilliard saw where the marker was down on the ground and tried to get the ball past that marker. But the marker on this side was a little bit short of where the marker is on the other side where the real chains are kept. Consequently, it looks like he's going to be a little bit short on the first down.
Now, we mentioned the big decision. Coach Arnsberger against Florida on fourth down went for the first down four times. And in this game, he faces that same situation now from the Arizona 24.
To Bill Arnsberger, this is not necessarily a big decision. This is just the way he wants to play football. He thinks that it is to his advantage to go for the fourth down right here, and he's going to do it. He's successful against Florida, and we'll see how he does here.
It's not quite as big a game, perhaps.
They're all
but
big.
In that famous 17-16 game, which Bert Jones don't so beautifully, there are a number of fourth down situations which occurred. First down. The Tigers go for it and pick up the first down.
And a good play that tells you a little bit about him, John, too, because they ran right up the middle. And, of course, you know who's right up the middle is Big Joe Drake, who Arizona relies upon a great deal to stop things in the middle. So that tells you a little bit about the philosophy LSU wanted to use.
Now the Tigers have it first and 10 at the Arizona Wildcat 23, down by 7, and Wickersham throws at Fontenot. Dumped at the 20. Arizona's a big team now. Greg Turner is first to make contact with Byron Evans, number 48.
Getting back to that short yardage play, they showed excellent coaching because they knew if they lean the formation to one side or another, Arizona more than likely would slant the line, which means they'll play to that way. Jeff set back, delayed a second, then went for the quarterback sneak behind the nose tackle.
Wickersham has Fontenot right and Rocky McGee left, and here's a pass beautifully caught but out of bounds by Eric Martin. And Wickersham doesn't like that at all because he really took a pop as he released the ball, and here that is. Martin up high catches it, and
good call.
Good call.
The right call.
Third down at the 20. And 7 yards to go. Arizona Territory, LSU to the ball, and down by 7.
Here comes
the air again. Here it is, and that's Martin again. First down at the 11. Behan there to contact, but too late.
That's an awful fine play, but the key to this play is the last time Jeff saw the blitz coming, he got hit. This time he knew he was going to get hit. Comes back, throws a fine pass, and Eric Martin, as I said earlier, always seems to catch the ball.
First down, 10 yards to go at the Arizona 11. LSU brandishing the big power again. Up back here is Craig Grafton, 13, but James gets the pitch out. Nothing much, and that play was fouled up by the defensive right cornerback Greg Turner. And good defensive play by Lamont Hundley from linebacker. Practically no gain. Second down coming up.
And Hundley's done an excellent job. His brother Ricky Hundley played that position for Arizona last year, was a first round draft choice in the NFL. They've moved Lamont Hundley over to the linebacker, and they moved the linebackers around a good bit to try to utilize them to the best of the individual ability of the player.
There's a little scissors play with James running up with it, going wide left. He has the feed inside the 5. Down at the 4-yard line by Gordon Bunch and Alan Durden. Good hitting out there, but an excellent run by Gary James. Again, misdirection, and James has the speed to carry it out.
And you see the speed and how important that is. James got kind of tripped up right after he got the handoff, and he had to get past the first defensive player. Once he did, though, he outran Hundley, almost got the ball down right to the goal line. He just quite couldn't turn the corner.
Third down at the 4. 3 to go for the first down, and 4 to go for 6 points. Arizona leads 13-6, LSU threatening. Going to run it, and Wickersham is down in inside the one. He doesn't have the touchdown, but he may have the first down, which may be just as important at this stage. He's caught by Steve Mobley.
A very heads-up play for Jeff right here. He sees his receiver. He kind of feels the pressure coming behind. He ducks a little bit, goes in, puts his head down, which I don't particularly like to see him do. And he gets the first down as they measure.
John, you know, I don't particularly like to see him do that, but I'll tell you, it really does an awful lot when a team sees its quarterback in a crucial situation put his head down and really play hardball. And sometimes a little thing like that is the one thing that makes an average player much more of a leader. And that may be something that will affect this team throughout the rest of this game.
Rasmus and James are behind Wickersham, and it'll be James who got the ball. He'll waltz in. The Tigers come to 12 points compared to Arizona's 13. And now the Tigers have culminated a 70-yard drive. And here it is again with James scoring the six.
And here's the pitch. James could have turned up right there to the goal line. Really don't know why he kept stringing it out, but I believe he knew he was going to score anyway. He could have done it without taking the tackle. As it was, they still count the same number of points.
And so many people take an extra point as automatic.
Juan Betances does automatic this one. And with 4:58 to go in the half, we have a tie ball game, and it's 13-13. And so, gentlemen, your comments, please, on the 70-yard drive. Bert?
I think it was a critical drive for LSU. Up until this stage, they've been able to move the ball with the exception of the last two times out, but they never got it in the end zone. They made the big mistake going in, one for a touchdown to go another way. As you see Gary James once again getting around the corner. The corner's been good to him here. He should have turned it up there, but 6 points is 6 points, as Doug says. But that's why that drive was so big for them, is it put them back in the momentum driving seat, as they say, and consequently put them on the board for 6 points.
And you know, you get the feel, LSU early in the game really had control of it until the interception that gave Arizona their touchdown. And from that point, you felt like the momentum changed completely, and that Arizona, although they were down statistically, had complete control of it. This drive, of course, it remains to be seen whether it's going to change that momentum. But when you go 70 yards and 16 plays, you take up 5 minutes. That really means a lot about your ability to control the line of scrimmage.
Was touchdown number 5 for Gary James this year. Back to Frank will kick off, and down the field you've seen Eugene Hardy and Vance Johnson. Johnson, remember, on the last kickoff received by the Wildcats, ran it back 37 yards, and the Wildcats moved on down the field to get some points. Squibb kick at the 25. They got it.
Ask a kicker, and I think I'll ask Matt after the game, do they really mean to squib it each time they do it, or do sometimes a kicker miss it? What do you think, Doug? You kicked a little bit, didn't you?
I don't believe that he meant to squib that one, because he's kicking the ball into the end zone routinely, and the ball's coming out to the 20. Here, Arizona got it on the 31, so if he did it on purpose, I think he's going to have a talk with the coach.
First down, the Wildcats at their 31. Fullback up the middle, short yardage. Bill Freeman for the second carry of the game.
And you see the defense for LSU kind of picking up, getting a little life in them. Stopping them for 2 or 3 yards.
They saw Jeff Wickersham put his head down, too. You know, that makes a whole lot of difference, doesn't it?
John Burton, Tommy Clapp, shoulder to shoulder on this tackle. They say just shy of the 34. It'll be second down and 8 yards to go. The Wildcats have a double wing set up with one remaining back. That's David Adams. Long count by Jenkins, maybe checking off. He's going to throw deep, and there's a flag behind the line, maybe holding by the offense, and a catch by Jade Dobbin, the flanker, hit by Burks. Now let's check out the flag, and Burleson is talking with the umpire. The league will use the hands and off.
You certainly should hope that it is holding, because Jenkins had a lot of time. If that was just simple pass protection, if you can block defensive people that long when they have so many of them coming at you, the defense will be in for a long night.
fortunate.
Would want to get hit by Rehage and Burks in any case, would you?
Would not. Rehage will take his shots when he gets them. He took some shots last week that he got flagged for a couple of times, but he's really an aggressive defensive player, and he can spark the secondary himself.
Now, we should point out that there are differences in holding and holding in college football as far as penalties are concerned. And when the official grabs his wrist and holds the palm of the hand up, that's only a 5-yard assessment as compared to a 10-yard otherwise. The shotgun, second down from the 29. 12 to go. Dickens has a lot of time again. Throws widely intended for the fullback Bill Freeman out of the backfield.
Unfortunately, he threw it behind him on that play because LSU had a blitz on there. Burks coming from this side, and it looked like Greg Dubrock was supposed to come all the way over and pick up that back to the slot side, but
he was way behind him, and he had plenty of running room on that guy.
And two, that blitz took a long time to get to the quarterback.
It didn't get to the quarterback, and they had it picked up well, and because of that, had they hit that receiver, he'd still been walking.
13-13 the score, less than 4 minutes to play in the first half. Third and 12, the Wildcats at their 29, Jenkins again. Way up the field, Horton has it. He can go, he's horse-counted inside the 25. We have a flag on the play, and there may be more yardage against LSU on the tackle. A 41-yard play, and Arizona's Wildcats come up with the big play again.
Here you're going to see Jay Dobbins. Jay Dobbins, outstanding receiver. He's a what they consider, or John Horton, an excellent professional football prospect. He's got tremendous speed. He catches the ball well. Sometimes he's unmotivated. Tonight he looks motivated. He caught the ball well that time. LSU with a face mask penalty that packs on to it. So that's a tremendously big play. And let's give the quarterback credit, too, Bo Jones.
He did. He looked off the weak safety of the man that's supposed to be playing in center field and just hit that receiver running right out through the zone in between the cornerback and the weak safety, and it was a fine play for them and a good throw and a good catch.
John Horton has the good hands and the good speed, and 5 yards are tacked on because of the face mask in a first situation, and it's first down at the LSU 17. 13-13, good ball game at Tiger Stadium. Dickens fakes the pitch out, throws a lateral out there to Johnson, going to the sideline. Out of bounds inside the 15. He gets 4 yards on the carry. And that's Kevin Guidry, number 27, riding the shoulders of Vance Johnson.
And if you don't think LSU respects Johnson's speed, on that play, Jeffrey Dale had him in the flat one-on-one. All he was trying to do here is keep him in play. Don't let him break past me. You see Jeffrey Dale coming up on your side there, playing back on him, not letting him get around the corner.
Second down, six to go at the LSU 13. David Adams. Cracked down by Dubrock on the way through the hole at the right side of the line, stopped shy of the 10.
You know, David Adams is so small that when you have that backside guard and that backside tackle pull through the hole and go up through there, I believe if I were on defense, I may not be able to see him.
Well, it shows you that there's a room in college football for little men. Here's one who's not all that big. Well put together, Dolphin Higgins of LSU. But David Adams falls in line with a lot of famous fellows who are very small who have great professional careers. Third down of the 11. Three to go. Arizona from the shotgun. Jenkins to throw. He's going to be chased back there. Does he get the first down? He may at the 6.
And there you see why Jenkins was the Los Angeles area player of the year in high school. He's a very versatile athlete. He's a good thrower, but when he feels the pressure, there we see him trying to pick up the offensive line and get it going.
That's Pete Mangurian, offensive line coach. And it's first down Arizona at the LSU 6-yard line. Wildcats mounting a big scoring threat here after a big 41-yard play plus a 5-yard penalty. With Adams, 5-yard line. And the play was turned in on the near side. And that was Jeffrey Dale who turned it in, and Dubrock and Sean Burks polish off Mr. Adams at the 5-yard line. Second down, goal to go. And up 150 yards last week against the Oregon State Beavers, who have played on this field. 13-13 is the score. Arizona and LSU with 2:03 to go in the first half. Jenkins, Johnson, touchdown, and Arizona is ahead of LSU 19-13.
John, Arizona did what they needed to do that time as far as utilizing ability. Johnson is out in the flat. Now, this is the long jumper with the tremendous speed, and Kevin Guidry just could not keep up with him, couldn't get to him. You see Johnson wide open. The ball did not have to be particularly well thrown, but it was thrown well enough for the touchdown.
That's Johnson's third touchdown reception of the year, and Zendejas, number 13, will try to make it one more point for Arizona. And the kick is good. 1:47 to go in the first half, and Arizona again has a 7-point lead over the LSU Tigers, and the Tigers, who had the momentum offensively, just couldn't stop the Wildcats coming back down the field. But of course, the whole thing hinged on the big play.
Well, that question, but that's what Arizona's offense is all set on, as you see Jenkins rolling to his right, showing that he has pretty good speed too. Getting the ball outside, and actually Johnson was open from the time he came out of his stance in the backfield. He could have hit him at almost any point, but I think Jenkins at one stage of that play was thinking about running it himself.
I think he was. He wanted to get some points up there. You know, LSU, we talked at the beginning of that Arizona drive how important that drive was. As you mentioned earlier in the game, Bert, every drive is very important, but LSU seemed to have taken over the line of scrimmage. And then at the beginning of the Arizona series, when they held them, it looked like the Tigers were going to be able to hold that momentum. But then the big pass play to Horton, plus the penalty, though not very long, put them deep in Tiger territory. And from that point, you know, the 69 yards went pretty fast. Took only 3 minutes, but it really reestablished a lot more than the lead in the scorebook.
And it showed really what Arizona's offense is pressing on, the big play.
Norman Jefferson and Herman Fontenot are deep. Max Zendejas will kick off. Last time he kicked off, he went past the end line with it. A little lighter this time, and Jefferson takes it at the goal line. 25-yard line. He was off balance back up the field, and Jefferson and Brent Wood were those who will get credit for the Arizona Wildcat tackle. But the clock shows 1:41 to go in the first half. The Arizona Wildcats have a 7-point lead over the LSU Tigers, 20-13. First down, the Tigers at their 25.
A minute 41 left in the half here. We'll see how Jeff takes it on now.
Draw play, Hilliard up the middle, has the ball, and has a first down. Good call, Alan Dirt, number 19, fills in.
And that was a good open field tackle. Dalton Hilliard is tough to tackle and would be tough to tackle in the phone booth. That time, Alan Durden held his ground and made a good tackle out in the open field.
Dalton Hilliard reminds me of Jell-O wiggling around out there. He's got more moves than anything.
Incomplete, almost intercepted. Wickersham was looking for Eric Martin, but Lamont Hundley almost picked that one off. Second down 10. The clock has stopped at 1:23 to go in the first half. And even though the Tigers got the momentum again here in the second quarter, that 96-yard interception return by Alan Durden and the return for a touchdown really took a lot of starch out of the LSU team early in the game. Wickersham back to throw. He's got James across the ball. James has maneuvered behind Brian Evans, number 36. But he dropped the ball.
John, LSU, the last couple of plays, has tried to run some little combination patterns where a receiver, Gary James, will go out in the flat and try to cut back across the path of another receiver in the crossing pattern. And what Arizona State has done is just take a linebacker there and block the way. They're just going ahead and taking shots at those receivers coming across the middle, impeding their progress, and Jeff Wickersham can't find an open man.
He's back again. Looking way around, and he shoots one that's over the head of Eric Martin. That's going to bring up fourth down, and the Tigers go nowhere on three quick tries, and did not seem really to be very organized on that particular series.
Well, the two-minute offense rarely looks too organized if you don't complete a pass, but they had some things going there. They came out with a good quick draw, get a little field position going, eat up a little time, and then they started moving the ball around in the pocket, which they're going to have to do to buy some time because Arizona is a good rushing team.
Parker kicked one, and a nice kick is on the way to David Adams at the 19. Scurrying to the near side, he's going to run down at the 29. 46 yards for Parker and a 9-yard return.
You know, Larry,
55 seconds left to go in the first half.
Larry Smith showed it again, John. His idea about the punting game when you're receiving a punt is to go ahead and try to block it a good percentage of the time. And if you're successful with it, and they've been successful, they've blocked 10 punts over the last 2 years, and they either partially blocked the first one or forced Clay Parker to kick it off the side of his foot. But if you do that, you force the punting team to stay in there and block longer, and it lets your punt receiver have a chance to run the ball.
Jenkins pitches out. Here comes Adams, countering and looking for room, and gets a little. Maybe 4 or 5 yards. Henry Thomas stays right with it. He's a fancy little runner. He saw nothing where the hole probably was supposed to go, and all of a sudden he cut back. Chapman met him there with help. Second down and about 5 from the 34-yard line. Less than half a minute to go in the first half. Fullback Freeman charging through, picked up about 5, maybe a little shy of the first down, as Carl Wilson makes the tackle for LSU with help from Ricky Chapman. These are the Arizona Wildcats of the Pac-10. They're unbeaten with victories over California and Oregon State in the Pac-10. Last year, this team beat UCLA, which became the eventual Rose Bowl champion.
Now, I'll tell you, John, were it not for that fluke defeat against Fresno State in the opening game of the season, these folks would be ranked, and they look like they have an excellent football team.
And the measurement shows it is first down at the 39-yard line. Arizona has another first and 10 with 7 seconds to go in the half.
But as you mentioned, unbeaten in their conference, and that's what's important to them at this point.
That's correct. Michael Brooks is number 94, sauntering around to the left side to pick up his position as outside linebacker on the left. And the clock is going to run out before a play can run. And so the coaches now will take over for the next 20 minutes in the dressing rooms. And the LSU Tiger Band, the Golden Band from Tigerland, will be performing in front of the people in the stands. Arizona watched LSU turn on the big power at the start of the game. LSU did not score a touchdown, however. Got ahead 3-0, and then an interception return for a touchdown, 96 yards in length by Alan Dirt, turned it around for Arizona. And the Wildcats have been in the thick of the fray ever since, and Arizona has a 7-point lead. And we'll be back in just a minute with more comments about the first half. Here's your halftime score. The Arizona Wildcats 20, the LSU Fighting Tigers 13.
It's halftime. The LSU Tigers on the short end of the scoreboard right now. It's 20-13. We'll be back with more of all the second half action from Tiger Stadium in just a moment. I'd like to briefly remind you that coming up next week, we'll have the delayed telecast as well at the same time, 10:30, on the LSU-USC game, so you be with us for all of that. It's now time for the Sunday Sports Final segment, and this weekend marks the first district action for most of our area high schools. Now, Newsline's featured game saw a couple of undefeated teams throw some real scares in their opening contests at the opposition, and Steve Schneider followed all the action.
Thursday night, the action from Olympia Field, District 7 Quad A. Bel Air's Bengals, undefeated at 3-0, taking on Glen Oaks, had their hands full. In the first half, Glen Oaks raced to a 21-0 lead. This is the second of 3 touchdowns they scored to put the scare to Bel Air. But Bel Air did come back. Touchdown in the third quarter, making it 21-7. And then Jody Caracciola, the fine 10th grade quarterback, gets the Bengals into the end zone again on this quarterback sneak. The score was 21-13. Bel Air coach Dave Lesage made a big decision at this point, opting for the two-point play. Graciola found Scott Tumpley in the right corner. That made it 21-15. Then fourth quarter, about a minute left in the game. Graciola again fires up the arm. Ronnie Miles down the left sideline, beat double coverage down to the 12-yard line. That set up the tying touchdown. Again, Caracciola to his favorite target. Scott Tomplay with a circus catch in the right corner of the end zone. The tie it at 21. Belair kicked the point and won it 22-21. They're 4-0 on the season. Just a sign of how tough 7 Quad A will be. Covington, Baker, and Denham Springs are all undefeated as well. Our other highlighted game was Friday night at Zachary, 6 AAA to district, and the first district game, Zachary playing Port Allen. These two teams figured to be at the top of the race when it's all over, and early on, Port Allen's Pelicans gave Zachary all they could handle. This interception and touchdown return by Darryl Gatto gave the Pelicans a 6-0 lead in the first quarter as they tried to unseat the two-time defending champion Broncos. But Victor Jones got things going for the Bronx. This long run down to the 3-yard line. He took it in on the next play, and Zachary did hold a 7-6 halftime lead. Port Allen got some luck involved in the third quarter to take the lead back. Quarterback Willie Butler throws right to the hands of defender Lance Butler, but it's off his hands, and Terry Jones miraculously gets into the end zone to make it 12-7. But that's about all the luck Port Allen would have on the night as Zachary struck for 2 long touchdowns in the fourth quarter. The final score, Zachary 20, Port Allen 12. Zachary 4-0 on the season and 1-0 in district play. Now next week we get back to District 6 Quad A. On Thursday night, the defending champion Capital Lions, who are struggling a bit, will host the Sandemont Gators. Then Friday night, Olympia Stadium, District 7 Quad A, it's the Belair Bengals again as they go against undefeated Denham Springs, the Yellow Jackets, one of the top-rated teams in the state. Should be another great weekend of high school football. This is Steve Schneider for the Sunday Sports Final.
All right, Steve, thank you. The New Orleans Saints defense came to life just in time to resurrect victory from the jaws of an overtime period this afternoon at the Superdome. Let's roll it from the Mushroom on Poydras Street and show you how it all happened. I think you'll see early that the Saints had some difficulty in getting their running game going. So what do? You throw the ball and you find your tight end. Hobie Brenner had 6 receptions on the day for 131 yards, that one going 57 yards in the first quarter to set up Morton Anderson's 25-yard field goal to make the score 3-0. Then Hokie Gaijon, as the lone setback, will throw a halfback option pass for a touchdown to Wayne Wilson. That one goes 36 yards. It's 10-0 New Orleans. Neil Lomax, though, counters. He finds his fullback, Earl Farrell, for an 11-yard toss. That makes it a 10-7 ballgame. Now watch this. This is right before the end of the half. Todd to Tyrone Young. The officials ruled he was out of bounds. They do not count it as a touchdown. Young couldn't believe it. And that means Morton Anderson will have to come on and hit again. This time from 32 yards. It's 13-7. That's the way it stood at halftime. But in the third quarter, Stump Mitchell, who had a great afternoon for the Cardinals, goes over from 7 yards out. That gives St. Louis their first lead, 14-13. But it was a short-lived lead. Look at here. Getter Fields breaks free, 56 yards, and Stump Mitchell was all that kept him from getting a touchdown. Mitchell with the tackle. That leads to this touchdown aerial, measuring 15 yards, as Todd finds Brenner again on the out pattern, and it's 20-14. But Stump Mitchell goes right back to work. Opening play of the fourth quarter, this 22-yard scamper makes it 21-20. The Cardinals take a 4-point bulge when Neil O'Donohue connects on this 38-yard field goal, and it's now a 24-20 game. But Todd finds Wayne Wilson on this touchdown aerial of 35 yards, and the Saints get the 27-24 lead. Late in the game, Cardinals moving. It's sack time. Gaithers makes the sack, Jackson the fumble recovery, and Bum Phillips obviously pleased to come out of there with a win.
I keep saying this over and over, and I'm going to repeat myself one more time. A football game is not over until it's over, and the season is not over until it's over. I think we played a football team. In fact, I know that football team was leading the league in offense. It's a good football team. They're a good, sound defensive football team. They're a good, sound offensive football team. So we expected them to make some yards, and they made some yards. We expected to beat them, and we did beat them.
All right, here are your scores. From the NFL, New Orleans, as we mentioned, beating St. Louis, the final 34-24. Washington down New England 26-10. San Francisco, they're still rolling. They might not have Montana, but they're still winning. They beat Philadelphia today at the Vet 21-9. The Rams over Cincinnati with their backup quarterback, Jeff Kemp, 24-14 the final. New York over Buffalo, 28-26. Minnesota edged Detroit by a point. It was Atlanta trouncing Houston, Cleveland clubbing Pittsburgh, Miami downed Indianapolis, the Giants beat Tampa Bay, Dallas drowned the Green Bay today, 20-6, Denver over KC, 21-0, and Seattle beat Chicago, 38-9. The Southern University Athletic Department has had its share of problems recently, controversies from losing players and coaches, to thousands of lost dollars in television and radio rights. But how about Otis Washington's Jaguars? Where would Southern be if it weren't for his unbeaten football team? With all the ineptness surrounding him, Washington's team has done Southern University proud. Last night, the Jags outlasted Prairie View in the mud, 28-7. Washington was especially pleased with his passing game.
Our passing game come to light tonight. Herman Coleman threw the ball well. We got Calvin McGee involved in our passing game and our running back. So with our running backs and Calvin in the passing game, I think that the way for the offense might be on track.
Were a few kinks to work out penalties. Once again, 100 yards in the first half. That's something you're just going to have to work on, I guess.
We had 100 and 106 yards. 10 penalties in the first half, 106 yards. That hurt. We gave up 100 yards. That's a football field.
Prairie View got close in the first half, late in the first half. You turned them away, and really that was the story most of the night. Your defense again playing a fine game, only giving up one touchdown.
Right now, we're probably the leading passing interception team in the nation. We picked off three tonight. It gives us 11 for the year.
It sets up a great matchup, Mississippi Valley.
Right. Well, that's going to be a good one next week. Hope the fans come out. I'm quite sure it'll be a lot of fireworks.
When a head coach is in trouble, misery seems to love company. That certainly applies to Tulane's Wally English. Now, we've learned today that it's likely he could be fired at the end of this current football season. Tulane was literally robbed of victory, 30-26. Yesterday, they lost to Kentucky. For English and his team, it was a very tough pill to swallow.
Well, I was sitting right there on the sideline, and obviously you're always a little prejudiced or partial to your own team, but Tylen caught the ball, and his right foot came down inbounds. I saw it. And it was shown on the instant replay, too, that he was inbounds. And the official said he got knocked back and he couldn't see it, and he called it no good. And then the other one, the ball, it was fourth down and like seven or something, and Curtis Bayham was back, and their punter, Calhoun, kicked the ball very deep, and Curtis was backing up and started to stumble and fell down, and Curtis swears to me he did not touch the ball. Ball came down, went into the end zone. They said, we touched him, we gave him a touchdown. Last year, I got all upset and started screaming, using some profanities about the officials, and I'm just not going to do that anymore because I think that comes back to haunt you, but there were some strange calls out there.
Finally tonight, in Major League Baseball, the Chicago Cubs now have won two ball games. The magic number has been reduced to one. If they win tomorrow, they will be the division champions in the National League East. The race is on in the West. Right now, Minnesota and Kansas City are tied for the top spot in the topsy-turvy AL West. So that's the story from Sunday Sports Final for tonight. Join us again next week. We'll have a halftime report during the delayed telecast of the LSU-USC game coming from Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum. So all of that is coming your way next week, so you make your plans to be here. Now we're going to take you back to Tiger Stadium. John Ferguson joined by Burt Jones and Doug Morrow for all the second half action in this exciting game between LSU and Arizona.
It's 20-13, Arizona over the LSU Tigers, and maybe the Tigers are just a little bit surprised. In any case, here are the stats. LSU has the better of the going, 217 total yards to 155, and 10 more first downs, and with the ball, almost 6 minutes longer. However, they pay off, as Doug and Bert have said, on what happens on the scoreboard, and that shows Arizona by seven. Here's the drive summary here by LSU, a 45-yard DeFrancis field goal, but then Arizona came back with a 96-yard interception return for 6 points, then a 38-yard field goal by DeFrancis, tie it up, and then James got ahead. 6 points there for LSU, and then Zandejas came back with a couple of field goals, and then Jenkins passed to Vance Johnson for a touchdown, and Zandejas kicked the point after, and we are at 20-13, Arizona.
I think the biggest thing you see from these drive summaries is the simple fact that Arizona offensively hasn't really established anything. They picked up a couple of big plays. They picked up 7 points on defense. And in other words, it's almost like LSU's mistakes are their good plays that have put them in this ball game. It also shows that Coach Smith, all he wants to do is get that big play. He's not trying to grind it out for 80 yards. He's trying to put it up in the air or get a quick running play that'll move the ball down the field. On the other side of the coin, LSU has had some good drives, but then they'll turn it over and then they won't get it into the end zone as they did early. But they've had some good drives towards the end of the half, and they did a good job of getting it in.
And you mentioned a good point there because they haven't established anything, but it looks like LSU defensively towards the end of the first half was waiting for Arizona to do something big, to come up with a big play, and they became tentative defensively, particularly on the Arizona touchdown drive at the end of the half, but even the few plays after LSU had the punt right at the end of the first half. I think LSU's got to reestablish themselves defensively at the line of scrimmage, become very aggressive, and really go after the football. You know, you mentioned on the pass, right before the Arizona touchdown, that Jeffrey Dale was backing off because he respected Vance Johnson's great speed. That's something that you don't normally see, though, a defensive back who has to back off rather than go forward to make the tackle. And LSU's got to get out of that routine and really go after the ball aggressively.
Arizona was pretty slow in coming out. Zendejas, however, is ready to kick off. Give LSU the football at the 30-yard line. If so, that's the second time Zendejas has been guilty of kicking the ball out of the field on the fly, and that brings into effect the new rule. So first down and 10 to go for the LSU Tigers at their 30. And the Tigers are trying to catch up 7 points and still get more. A running play. Here's Hilliard. 5 yards, out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Durden, number 19, leads the Arizona Wildcat charge. It'll be interesting to see in the first couple of minutes, as Hilliard has 75 yards now, what effect the coach's comments at the halftime have made on these players, particularly on the LSU side. To the short side of the field, Hilliard again, first down. Still digging. Out of bounds at the 44. Good run as Lyndon Brown holds on. 9-yard gain. And Durden also helps on the tackle, and that's Dalton Hilliard. And he has the good leg drive. Well, of course, with a pair of thighs such as his, he ought to be able to get something.
John, you know, another thing we might look for is to watch out strategically how the coaches have reacted to each other. Both of these teams are pretty much finesse teams, and we'll see what changes they've made strategically.
Here's James looking for the outside, picks up a yard. Tracked down by Greg Turner, number 40. Second down, 9. Comment on Hilliard indicates that he is very well developed between his body and his knees. He really does have great thighs, and that's how he gets all the leg drive. He really is quite a runner, as is Gary James. Second down, 9. 20 for Arizona, 13 for LSU, early in the second half. In the slot right, James, he gets the ball, goes wide left. Stutter step, gets the yardage for it, he can go. He's at the 30. He's out of bounds at the 22-yard line. Spun off by Turner and Durden. And it's a big run of 32 yards by Gary James. And the little stutter step behind the line breaks it for him.
You're going to see him do something. Defense closed on him, and he was able to get people to turn themselves to the inside and run right around him. He almost had enough speed to break it all the way.
Good block for Herman Fontenot, too, on the play. And here's a draw with Hilliard, bumped by number 47. That's Steve Boadway.
We really haven't said a whole lot about Steve Boadway today, but he's an All-American candidate coming from Arizona, and he's really the stalemate of that Arizona defense. Bill Osbarger said that he plays similar to what A.J. Dewey did for him while he was in Miami. They put him all over the field. They blitz him a lot. He's a gifted athlete, and he's got great range, and he has a feel for the ball, and he's their keynote defensive player.
Remaining back is Hilliard. Quick pass to Fontenot. There he goes. No, that's Eric Martin, isn't it? Number 41, it is Martin. And he gets about 5 yards on the carry, down to around the 17 as Bunch and Durden run him off the field. And on Hilliard again, gentlemen, LSU is making a different type of position out of fullback with number 21 in there.
As they are, they're removing the fullback position entirely from
that's
the
right.
football field. But that's not a bad move because both of these backs, Hilliard and James, are good blockers.
Wickersham to throw, rifles it, incomplete, and blocked by number 19, Alan Durden. And Martin was really covered on the play, and Wickersham did not look to the other side where he had Andrews.
Well, it's hard to go all the way from one side of the field to the other, especially when you're down in there. There are two places on the football field that are most important not to throw an interception. One is when you're going in to score, as we did down here, and the other one is when you're coming out, because either one of them typically results in a 7 or 14 point turnaround.
With Clay Parker holding, Juan Betances tries a 34-yard three-pointer. It's on the way. It's no good, off to the right. And so a 13-18 to go in the third quarter. The score remains 20-13. LSU comes up dry on a good drive down the field as Betances misses from 34. Doug?
Well, it looked like LSU was going to reestablish themselves. They came out, and you mentioned, John, that it was going to be interesting to see what they did. And they came out, rather than the short passing game, they came out three runs immediately to the weak side, made good yardage on the first two, got stymied on the third. James then made a nice run, but then Arizona shut them down. LSU's come away with no points.
And here is David Adams, wide right, and he's making a turn, and he's knocked down by Hobley. Gain of 4 yards on the play. Second down, six coming up.
Each time you see David Adams run around the end, it's almost like Dalton Hilliard changed uniforms because they look so much alike on the football field. Even though Dalton's a little bit bigger running back, they both have the jitterbug style, a lot of quickness in their feet, good lateral motion, and both of them will spin, as you'll see, quite often coming from them. But there it goes in. It fakes to the inside, which is, as Doug said earlier, a gift that you have to have and have to feel to bounce it back out to the outside.
From the shotgun, Jenkins to throw. Incomplete. That pass was intended for Gary Parrish, the tight end. Dubrock, the defender for LSU, number 44. Well, we have almost a full house. The last time LSU played a Pac-10 team, the record for attendance was set. That was last year against Washington. Over 82,000 were here then. Jenkins fakes the handoff. He's going to be wrapped up behind the line. Michael Brooks sacks Jenkins from the blind side. And on the third down and sixth play, that brings up fourth down at about 14. Here it is again.
Time again, you'll see Michael Brooks come up with a big play from Russell, Louisiana there. He just evades the blocker, gets around, and meets Jenkins right in the kisser.
He can play football, can he?
But it has nothing to do with where he's from.
Troy Lawton will kick up the field. Jeffrey Dale at his 45. Line drive kick. He could run this one a little bit. There goes Dale up the middle. Well, he's not known as a real punt return specialist, but he is dependable in catching the ball. And he runs it back shortly, 7 yards after a 37-yard Arizona kick. The official attendance tonight is 78,052. That's the ninth best attendance to date in LSU football history.
But they've been kind of quiet tonight, John.
From the 48, Wickersham to throw, pumps once, throws down the middle, open! Game! First down at the 22. Gary James just fell down after catching one that's good for 26 yards. And Wickersham had the mustard on that one, all right.
He had the mustard on it, but more important than the throw, which was good, fine throw, is Jeff gave it a little pump action, which broke that weak safety up and out of position to defend on that play. And consequently, they got a big gain. And here you see him running the center again.
And there goes Hilliard, dancing to the 20. He was caught on the way through. David Wood, the left tackle, the man who has him around the knee.
You can understand why Jeff Wickersham is having to throw the ball so much. LSU's running game in the middle is an example of why Arizona is ranked number 3 in the country against the run. They just are very tough. They've only given up 49.5 yards. LSU has more than that this evening, but they're tough to run against.
Second down 8 from the 20. Wickersham, a lot of time, throws to the end zone. And that's good. Touchdown, LSU. The defender, Gordon Bunch, went on past Fontenot, who waited for the ball, makes a nice leap, and catches for 6 points. And the Tigers throw to within 1 point. Here's the replay of it right here.
This is just a great individual play on Herman Fontenot's play here. The ball looked as if it was partially tipped. The defender was on it like a wet blanket, but he just played the ball like the best basketball player getting a rebound you can see. He caught it at the highest point, brought it down, and it's 6 points for the Tigers.
Matanzas will try to add the point after to lock it up again. It's good. Timeout of the game with 11:27 to go in the third quarter, and it's a new game again. LSU 20, Arizona 20.
Make no mistake about it. Narcotics is one of the greatest problems in America today. Because Baton Rouge is a major port, we're particularly vulnerable to filthy narcotics trafficking. As district attorney, my job is to convict the pushers, and this I've done. My conviction rate is 92%. Am I satisfied? No, and I never will be. Not until we've got the poison off our streets and the pushers behind bars where they belong. Please help me continue to do this job for all of us.
District Attorney O.C. Brown.
This is the first ever meeting between Arizona's Wildcats and the LSU Tigers. Tigers last week had 430 yards rushing. They won't get anything like that tonight, but Tigers are winning this physical battle, but it's a tie game, 20-20. After Frank kicking off, squib kick is bouncing back to the 9. And that's Hardy carrying the ball. Wow, what a hit by Steve Rehage. And Rehage comes off the worst for it, but the stop is made. That was quite a blow, they say, at the 21-yard line.
Steve Rehage puts himself in such a vulnerable position because he hits so hard. And each time he hits with his helmet. Watch him coming off the... There he is, sizing him up, and boom, head to head. And that hurts. That's the kind that breaks helmet.
I bet Eugene Hardy doesn't feel real good. Eugene is not on the ground, but that lick, whenever you hit head up like that, has to hurt both people. Hardy got up and ran off the field. Rehage very seldom stays down on the ground, but it's a wonder with the tremendous contact he's been involved in that he's not been left on the field more often than he has.
And again, an observation here, a thing like that, though tough on Rehage, and he's now getting up, as you see, it may mean that the Tigers will get some fight out of that.
Without question. I hope he can stand up all the way to the sidelines, because I can tell you, by looking to see Rehage, I'm not sure he knows where he is.
First down at 10 yards to go. Rehage gave everything he had on that tackle, and this is the cheer for him. Catch first and 10 at their 21 in a 20-20 battle. It's a toughie. Jenkins to throw. Horton has it. He caught the long one for 41 yards earlier, but he only gets about 6 or 7 out of this one. Tommy Clapp hangs on to him.
He reached up on that one and pulled it out of the sky. That was up in the interception area, down the middle, high, people behind the ball.
Now it's second down and 3, a 7-yard gain. That's Horton, number 86. He's a sophomore from Tucson, 182-pounder. You saw his stats. From the hash mark on the other side, running play up the middle, Nothing for Charlie Webb, new fullback of the game. The Tigers are pumped up with Thomas and Wilson. And we've not seen Roland Barbe, who had a twisted knee last week. Just one play
earlier today, and he wasn't dressed out on the sidelines. His knee has hurt him bad enough that he's elected not to dress out for this game.
I think, and I'll tell you, after this play, I had a discussion with one of the team doctors.
Third down and three. Shotgun again, and two receivers set to the left. Jenkins throwing into the zone. It's going to be intercepted at the 45. That's Copley. He's going. He's at the 10. He's dumped by the passer at the 9-yard line. It's first down and goal to go. We have a flag on the play. And let's go back up the field and check the flag on this 36-yard interception return down to the 9-yard line.
And quite often, no, it's not. Looks as if it's against Arizona.
Here comes Dick Burleson, and he says, illegal receiver downfield, and so here's the play again as Hobley takes the tip pass at the 45, comes into the picture, and here he is. That's his first interception of the year. It's a huge one for the Tigers.
Once again, getting back to the play earlier when he threw the ball high over the middle with people behind him. The receiver reached up and grabbed the one earlier, but that one, it was just a little bit higher. He wasn't able to, and as we said earlier, it's very vulnerable to the interception.
Here's the play as Hilliard bumps up the middle. He's at the 5. He's at the 1. Touchdown for Dalton Hilliard on a great run right up the middle. The Tigers are ahead in the game.
And the emotion of this team right now.
Juan Betanzas will try to give the Tigers their first 7-point lead of the game. He's got it. Time out of the game of 9:47 to go in the third quarter. Your score is LSU 27, Arizona 20.
It's easy to talk about the problems we face in Baton Rouge. What really matters, however, is results. Metro Councilman for District 11, Ben Peabody has listened to our problems and then worked to solve them. He has fought to protect our neighborhoods from commercial intrusion, to help improve our streets and drainage, to build a stronger ethics commission, and led the fight to get the drunk driver off our streets. While others talk about what they're going to do, Ben Peabody is getting the job done for all of us. Ben Peabody, Metro Councilman, District 11.
Has the ball from about the 20 up to the 28. Don Behan runs it back outside the 30-yard line. Marlboro and Nicky Hazard are in the vicinity of the tackle at the 28-yard line. Arizona has it first and 10. Now, Arizona's strategy would probably not call for a change here. Still throwing, and another interception to put the thing on ice for LSU, but let's see what happens. Jenkins barking out the count from the shotgun. Hands off, that's David Adams. Short yardage, the Tigers have it and really pile him up. Sean Burks, one of those to get there quickly, and Ricky Chapman and Greg Dubrock. And a further report on Roland Barbe.
John, Roland spoke with his family and the Tiger coaches and the doctors, and they've scheduled surgery for him on Monday. They hope that he'll be given this year again in eligibility, but felt it was in the interest of his health and the team that he do that. So it looks like he'll be out for the season.
Second down is the 38 yards to go. Run to the left by Jenkins. He's going to keep it. 5 yards. Hit head on there. Tackle shy of the 40-yard line. A 9-yard gain has the first down, it appears.
And talking about Roland there, getting an operation in the next couple of days, shows just how this LSU medical staff really is. Here you'll see Jenkins, a gifted thrower, a fine runner, had a man open, but elected that I think I'll take this one on my own. And that shows to me sometimes a little lack of confidence after having thrown an interception in the backfield.
Kevin Guidry made that open field tackle at the 39. First down, Arizona. LSU has a 7-point lead now. Jenkins to the air again. Incomplete. He overthrew widely. Reuben Berry, the split end, number 3. There's Coach Bill Arnsparger, who really has shown us again a different kind of coach on the sidelines. And he is a man who has really been in complete control, Bert.
I played against Bill Arnsparger too many years to know that without question he is in control. He knows what everything is that's going on the football field. There you see him with a headset. He doesn't need a headset because he can tell just through osmosis what's going on out there.
Second down, 10. Jenkins. That's Jay Dobbins. Has the ball at the 50-yard line. It'll be a first down. He gets 11 yards on it.
And Jenkins throws the ball well, just enough to keep him moving upfield. He's thrown some bad passes this half. And Bert, as you mentioned, he's thrown basically high this half. And looks like he's lost a little confidence. And then all of a sudden, bam, he throws this ball on the line, throws it in a position where only Dobbins can catch it, and throws it at a time when they need the first down. And that's what they have right at midfield.
First down, 10 yards to go at the 50-yard line at the near hash mark. Here are the stats on Jenkins. Big fella stands 6'4", draw play, Freeman. Linebackers have it, push it back to the 50-yard line, and he'll get credit for about 3 yards on the carry. There's Brooks on the sideline, Norman Jefferson. And here's the replay, and Freeman carrying, and there's Chapman 37. Clapp just misses him at the line. Sean Burks wraps him up with Dubrock. Second down, a long 7 to go, just inside the 48. Tiger territory, 7:40 to go in the third quarter. Well, she has a 7-point lead. It's a good game. Jenkins, a long throw, way down there. That's Horton in the end zone. He misses the ball. Had it in his hands. He was being covered there by Hobley. But Horton got on the inside, and the ball got in his hands, and when he hit the ground, it squirts away. It's no touchdown, but a great effort.
Jenkins rearing back. Looks as if he's thrown it just about as far as he can throw the ball, and Horton shows good speed, bounces in his hands, hits his chest, and back to the ground. Incomplete. Could have been 6 points for them.
It should have been 6 points for them.
Third down, a long 7. And Jenkins threw that ball 65 yards.
It should be about as far as he can throw.
Third down. And the shotgun again. Jenkins, number 1, is back again. Will he do it again? He's going to throw long again. Not quite as long as Horton. Catches the ball in the crowd this time for a first down. Two Tigers ran together at the 38-yard line, and Horton ends up with the ball. Dale and Chapman hit together, and Chapman is going to come out of the game, replaced by Burks. But Jenkins just goes along, and here it is again. We'll see the action here. A good catch again by Horton.
And Horton got sandwiched there on the reception, and you can tell that he felt it, but he didn't get hit nearly as hard, I think, as Chapman got hit.
And Dale.
And Dale.
Say hi, Mama.
First down at the LSU 38, and the Wildcats are moving relentlessly. Jenkins is being chased by Brooks. He's going to have to run, and he's going to get past the 35 to the 30, and is spun down by Toby Caston. He got away from Clarence Osborne and Michael Brooks.
A lot of enthusiasm, Doug, for a 9-yard gain on LSU's defensive part. See, Jenkins once again rolling out, looking for a receiver. Can't find anyone, but he just turns it up, and he's got good speed.
I tell you, you can tell he's strong.
he takes his blocker who gets in his way and just pushes him out of the way and keeps on going.
Wildcats have moved from their 28 to a second down and one at the LSU 29. Down by seven, the Wildcats are really battling hard. Jenkins to throw again, going deep. Nobody there. He overthrows on purpose, perhaps, Jay Robbins. Dobbins it is, and Jay was triple covered. And what was Caston doing all the way back there on that cover?
Showing he's got good speed.
Third down one. That was the waist down of the series, and Jenkins is now 8 for 22. Possession down for the Wildcats. There's Johnson. He's going to be caught behind the line. Won't get it. Freddie Lewis makes the tackle for LSU, and Caston helps and has a hard time containing himself, and here's the play again.
And you're going to see a big play because first Dale comes up and makes the force. Then everyone from the inside fills, first Sean Burks, and then he's supported by the entire linebacking corps.
Fourth down, and there will be a try for a 50-yard three-pointer at the north end by Zendejas. Max Zendejas is 6'1", 53 this year, his longest 54, and his kick is on the way. It's good, a 50-yard field goal by Max Zendejas. 5:20 to go in the third quarter, and here's your score with a timeout on the field. LSU 27, Arizona 23.
Make no mistake about it. Narcotics is one of the greatest problems in America today. Because Baton Rouge is a major port, we're particularly vulnerable to filthy narcotics trafficking. As district attorney, my job is to convict the pushers, and this I've done. My conviction rate is 92%. Am I satisfied? No, and I never will be. Not until we've got the poison off our streets and the pushers behind bars where they belong. Please help me continue to do this job for all of us.
District Attorney O.C. Brown.
Back to Dejas. It's the three up there for Arizona. A 50-yarder.
Could have gone 65 the way it cleared upright.
Down the field, Gary James, 33, and Norman Jones. Or Herman Fontenot it is. James is going to go to a knee and not run it out. First and 10, the Tigers then at their 20.
You see what Max Zendejas did? He kicks two of them out of the back of the end zone, and so on that kickoff, he only took two steps. He took the same number of steps you take on a field goal, still kicked it 5 yards deep in the end zone.
And he didn't, I don't understand why he went back to his run the last time, because the previous time he kicked it out of the end zone, he came back and just did a three-step and did just what he did then, deep in the end zone. I think he forgot.
He's good.
Without question. Bionic leg.
That's Hilliard for a couple of yards. Nothing much there. Second down at 8 yards to go. Well, Alfred Jenkins is an outstanding player. Vance Johnson is, and Max Zendejas surely is. And here is that little counter again. A little reverse to this side with James carrying. Almost gets away. But he's spilled there by number 47, Steve Bodway, and is down at the 25-yard line. So in two plays, the Tigers have gained 5 yards. James carries here for three, and it's third down and five. LSU has a four-point lead.
You know, LSU, it looks like when they scored the last touchdown, had kind of taken control, but Arizona keeps fighting back and making the big plays when they need to make them, and they're right here where LSU's on the ropes again.
Wickersham throws incomplete at the 35-yard line, looking for number 80, Roger McGee, who hasn't caught a pass tonight. And the Tigers are unspectacular in a possession here and will have to punt. Parker is coming in to do that.
As you see, Jeff is getting...
Everybody's on the line. Let's look here. 11 men on the line. No, 10 men on the line for Arizona. Obviously, Burt trying to block the punt. Let's see what Parker does with it. And they come, and he kicks. Good kick. David Adams to receive at his 28. Mostert at the 35. Cruz makes the tackle. A 6-yard return of a 46-yard kick.
47-yard kick.
Watching Jeff get up off the ground. He's been doing that a lot today. They haven't sacked him too much, but they've been getting real close, and that kind of disturbs a quarterback to have to get up every time he throws the ball. Not saying that he has, but a lot of that can pay its toll later in the game.
First and 10, the Wildcats have got three in their last possession and a 41-yard drive. They have the ball first and 10 at the 35, and Jenkins is to throw.
What?
Incomplete. Almost got an interception there. Burks almost had it. Hobley almost had a chance at it. And it's incomplete.
And this is really fun to watch, John and Bert. The teams are going back and forth. Arizona has such a wide open offense. And particularly Jenkins is just erratic enough where he throws some close to interceptions and some he completes. But he really is fun to watch throwing it.
LSU 2-1 ahead of Arizona in the total offense area. Jenkins rolling and throwing and out of bounds. Incomplete. Good defense over there by number 27, Kevin Guidry. And we have a discussion.
And we got a flag over there too, John. Larry Smith was not very happy, apparently, about the call that was made that the catch was out of bounds. There's a yellow flag over there on the sideline.
Now, there is an infraction called interference from the bench. That's fairly new to football rules, and a non-contact foul or unsportsmanlike conduct is surely being called right here. Larry Smith doesn't like it, but it'll hurt him.
I wonder what he
said. 15 yards coming up right here.
You ever wonder what they say over there, John?
We had a microphone over there, but we had to turn it off.
Jenkins rolling out on this, and he shows he can throw the ball on the run pretty well, too. As the ball is there, but Guidry is there also to knock him out of bounds, so it's not a completion.
A 15-yard penalty against Arizona. On the bench across the field, puts the ball back to the Wildcat 20-yard line. It's third down at 25. On the shotgun again. The Wildcats are going to that almost exclusively. That's like old-time football back in the 30s. Flags everywhere. Too much time, maybe.
Another illegal procedure. Left tackle for Arizona stepped back before the snap.
Now, you men wouldn't remember this, but I would. But this is the kind of football teams played. Maybe with not as many wide people, but the same type of formation way back when your daddy was playing, Bert.
Well, he wasn't playing in the 30s. He was back in the 50s.
Well,
but I think they were playing the same type of football.
Now, you don't know what they called it on here. I don't know if they called it on Larry Smith for pushing Jeff Riddell, because I don't think he pushed him. He slipped down trying to get past him. But at any rate, it cost him 15 yards, and those were big yards.
Third and 25. From the shotgun again. Jenkins. And he has a receiver. 17 yards on this reception Barnett. Run by Rory Barnett. Barnett the fullback. But he's a long way from getting a first down, and so Troy Lawton, number 5, will have to come in and punt. The point of the down is the Wildcats 32. And backing up, Norman Jefferson. Wouldn't it be nice to see him run one back? He did a year ago.
Yes, indeed.
Fourth down, long yardage, and Lawton kicks. Nice kick again. The punting's just been great in this game. From the 21-yard line, LSU will take over as Jefferson comes up with a fair catch. 47-yard kick on this one for Lawton.
For only 3 years. But already a new certainty about our future. Yes, a future demanding aggressive and intelligent leadership. Pat's Green. His innovative ideas are protecting our lives, like EMS, Emergency Medical Service. Pat's Green's vision is rebuilding our past and creating new jobs for the future. Catfish Town and Riverfront Redevelopment. His progressive promotion of our community has won for Baton Rouge the 1985 National Sports Festival, America's Olympics. Pat's Green. Green has shaped new initiatives against crime. New initiatives that have resulted in the first drop in our crime rate in a decade. And his tough approach has demanded more from our limited resources and has meant improved basic services for all of us. We are certain, but should we be? Yes, we can be. When you think about our future, Pat's Green makes sense today.
This year, and here's Wickersham pitching back to Hilliard. Flag, and down he goes at the 29. We may have a clip here.
I want to find out what happened when that flag got hung up in your mask on that thing.
Well, I picked it up, threw it right back at him.
Did he throw it back at you and give you 15 yards?
No, he just laughed as I did. The unfortunate aspect is I was fixing to throw the ball, and because that happened, I didn't, and ended up taking a sack, and they refused the penalty, got the sack, and I'm glad they didn't get me for verbal abuse on that one. They probably could have.
Well, they got LSU for 15 yards here.
No, I think five, Doug. Illegal use of hands and arms, and so I think the toss of the flag was more demonstrative than the penalty called for, but we'll have a little penalty stepped off here, and I think five, no, it's going to be 10 yards. Back to the 15.
I think on that one, I think we'll be looking at the tight end, Mitch Andrews. It was the oh-so-familiar, takedown block. It's one of these guys, we'll hug for a little while, and then we'll fall backwards together. The only thing is probably his arms got stretched out a little bit too far.
And back is Wickersham. Jeff Cox's arm throws a screen left, and that's Hilliard with it. He's at the 23. Good defensive play by number 15, left cornerback Gordon Bunch. And he stopped Hilliard from going a long, long way with that action right there.
He stopped him from getting a bunch on that one.
The screen pass. Bert Jones loved the screen pass. He didn't get a chance to throw for any when he was in college.
No, we didn't have that one in our offense. But we had a lot of good things in our offense.
Yeah, that's correct. And a lot of good things were made. Second down, 9. And Wickersham again throws quickly out here. And that's going to be DeFontenot backing up to the 27. Short gain. Again, Bunch on the tackle playing the near side. And he hurt himself there on that stop. Fontenot made a great catch in the end zone down at the other end of this quarter, which has 1:56 remaining in it.
Doug, Herman was bothered earlier in the year with a sprained ankle. Looks like his ankle has come back around, and he's performing just as he always could and should do.
And he seems to be anxious to make this a really great season for him. He's very capable.
Wickersham on 3rd and 5, being chased and trapped way behind the line. That thing just never did develop. Lost 10. Or so back to the 17-yard line. Back there on that one was Jim Birmingham, and so here it is again.
You've just got a blitz coming up the middle. David Wood coming right in there makes the play on Jeff. He really hadn't got a whole lot of choice, and he did the right thing. Sometimes you have to chew on that football back there.
Parker with 10 men on the line to rush. Gets a snap, good one, and boots the ball in plenty of time. Not quite as long as some others. Adams takes it and is hit immediately by Chris Carrier, the man who snapped back the ball. 31 yards on the kick and no return. Well, a 31-yard kick with 0 yards on the return is just as good as a 50-yarder that's run back 20 yards. Took me a while.
Doing math, well,
that's, that's why he's in analysis.
Is that what it is? I was wondering what you were doing when you were spinning that little wheel over there, John. Does that tell you?
That tells me.
I tell you, if LSU keeps moving backwards this way, old Max is not too far away from 3 more points right here.
58 seconds to go in the third quarter, and Jenkins retreats to throw. Screen pass up the middle. Johnson gets short yardage, 3 in fact, and goes right down as he is hit by Ricky Chapman.
And it was just kind of a matter of time before they threw this. LSU has not gotten much pressure on the passer, but they've tried to, and they're trying to do different things. AC Greg Dubrock was brought in to rush the passer, and so Arizona comes back with the screen, and if Johnson doesn't go down, he has a good chance of making a long gainer out of that.
Second down, 7 at the LSU 46-yard line. LSU leads by 4 with 20 seconds to go in the third quarter, and here is a little inside handoff and no gain on this run by Freeman. Thomas and Burke stop in. Third down. In with the play comes a man from the other side, and time runs out in the third quarter. At the end of the third quarter, the score is LSU 27, Arizona 23.
Make no mistake about it. Narcotics is one of the greatest problems in America today. Because Baton Rouge is a major port, we're particularly vulnerable to filthy narcotics trafficking. As district attorney, my job is to convict the pushers, and this I've done. My conviction rate is 92%. Am I satisfied? No, and I never will be. Not until we've got the poison off our streets and the pushers behind bars where they belong. Please help me continue to do this job for all of us.
District Attorney O.C. Brown.
Cats have third down and seven at the LSU 46. The Wildcats have run very sparingly and have thrown a great deal here in the second half. In fact, all night. And fake to the tailback, and here he comes. Jenkins is going to be hit by Carl Wilson, and first of all by Henry Thomas.
This was a good play on LSU's defense because what they, in effect, had was three receivers to one side, which really overloads an offense, and it puts a real bind on the defense. They had to come up with almost a man coverage within the zone, and they did a fine job leaving no one open and making Jenkins run the ball.
From the LSU 47, Lawton to punt. Jefferson down deep, and the kick is going to be fair caught by Jefferson at the 11. And so 37 yards for Lawton.
37-yard kick.
LSU has the ball, first and 10 at the Tiger 11-yard line. That's Norman Jefferson, number 12.
And LSU really needs to make several first downs here to get out of there into the field, John. The last two series have started down there, and they're moving back slowly, 4 or 5 yards, the change of possession, which certainly is advantageous to Arizona. LSU's got to get out there, get up near midfield, and try to establish some good position.
Martin is wide left, and Fontenot is to the right. The pitch out goes to Hilliard.
And by losing that ground on just turnovers, that shows you how important a kicking game can be. They started out on the 30, changed possessions, came on back to the 20, changed possessions, came back to the 10-yard line. So that means, in essence, a minimum of a 10-yard turnaround.
There's Bill Spencer, state trooper.
Hi, Bill. Hope I don't ever meet you on the highway.
He's one of the good ones in the blue. From the 15, broken play. Here is Wickersham going to run it, and he's up for a first down. Wisely takes to the ground.
You know, that thing may end up in the offense next week.
Well, he was looking for someone to whom to hand the ball, but no one was there, and so he just decided I better run it.
Gary James on this one looks as if he went the wrong way because everyone else came this way, and a good play developed. Had it been a real running back, it could have been a lot more yards.
I'll tell you, I think what happened, Arizona is watching their linebackers, are watching James. They see him go one direction, and they figure, heck, you know, that's the guy that's going to get the ball. And in essence, Wickersham ends up with a bootleg with several blockers in front of him.
And first down. Here goes James. He's going to throw a halfback pass. Man is in the open. That's Roger McGee. First down. He could have gone all the way. Lyndon Brown smelled out the play, but it goes for 27 yards. And McGee's first catch of the game is a big one.
Pretty brazen offensive play here. Here's a guy that's not used to throwing. It's a critical drive. But it's first down, and you can do a lot of things on first down after you've established a little bit by getting two first down. He comes up, throws the ball downfield, and that's when to do it.
Roger McGee, freshman from Bogalusa. First down, LSU at the Wildcat 47, and here goes Hilliard. Little trap play brings him the better part of 6 or 7 yards. Bodway is one of the tacklers, as is John Barthol, number 99.
On that play, you can see a disadvantage in being a real big lineman sometimes, because if you ever get started in one direction, there you see Dalton has cracked the 100-yard barrier, 22 rushes for 110 yards.
That's 10 100-yard games he's had in his career.
That's
second down,
ever,
a short five, and here's James. A flag by the linesman, as he crawls ahead for an apparent first down. But let's check the infraction.
Looks early. Typically means somebody on offense moved or they lined up off sides. But I guess that's why we wait to see what he says.
Illegal procedure against LSU.
You knew already, didn't you?
No.
Well, maybe you told him because he called what you said. And either way, it takes that first down away, and that second and 10 is not nearly as much fun to look at as second and about five.
But she is.
Another beautiful Louisiana woman, John.
That's correct. A lot of them at LSU. Second down and a short 10 now from about the Wildcat 47-yard line. LSU clings to a four-point lead with 12 minutes to play. There goes James. And Joe Drake was one of those trailing along to try to make the tackle. I like to see that big man move. I think he's extremely agile to be such a heavyweight.
I understand they take him down to the feedlot to weigh him.
Not a bad idea. Those are the LSU cheerleaders. They work just about as hard as the football team, and hours rehearsed. Third down and eight at the 45 Wildcat territory. And Wickersham to throw against the blitz. He shoots. That's Martin at the 25. Good catch, crossing over, and he gets 5 yards after the catch, and Durden rides it down. But that's another good play between those two.
It's a bad combination. Here you'll see Dalton Hilliard. Some people say he's too small to block. Look at him taking over it on the inside. He just kept that linebacker from getting any penetration, allowing Jeff to just set up, throw the ball on a man-on-man situation, which is a quarterback's dream.
Eric Martin, a prominent mention for All-America honors, and here goes Hilliard. One of the top running backs in the conference, and he is ahead to about the 22, the 21 with Drake in the middle of the activity there. And also David Wood, number 92. There's the Tiger bench, that's Tommy Clapp turning around. Dubrock is on his left, and 96 is Thomas, who won his job in the spring, and we have a Tiger who's shaking up on the play. Let's see who that is.
That's going to be Eric Handel, second. LSU really can't afford to lose anyone at that position. Jeff Fordham, with a back problem, is going to be out for the season. Eric Andelsek came in, and as a freshman from Thibodeau, was given a lot more playing time than was expected. He's the one who's down on the field. I don't know how serious the injury is, but anytime you're down and can't get up on your own.
Well, it's not a knee, apparently, or an ankle, and that is a good thing.
Coming in, we're trying to see if we can see it.
Well, we can't see where he is, but somehow he just got messed up in there. Up to this time, Arizona has 65 yards rushing. Hilliard of the Tigers has 114, and James has 72. It's second down. The Tigers are at the 21-yard line, Arizona territory. And here comes James. Slides off the field at the 16-yard line. Now, you think about the condition of the field. I want to make a comment about this gorgeous place. After all the heavy rain today and that yesterday afternoon as we watched James again, and the heavy rain of last night, and the field not being covered 100% of the time, this field is in magnificent condition.
It is in excellent condition. You saw Gary James' feet slip out that time at the end of the run. But in all fairness, you can't blame that on the field. He often has a tendency to run on the side of his feet when he's making a cut. Also, a lot of the players wear shorter cleats than you would normally wear on kind of a damp field.
Third down one. Here's Wickersham to throw or run. He'll have to hurry. Won't get it away. Too bad. Tackling there, David Wood and company. Let's look at that one again.
And here you're going to see the same pattern. Now that they've thrown a number of times out in the flat, and it was one that was almost picked off for a touchdown, Jeff saw quickly that it was covered and wisely elected not to throw the ball to the primary receiver, but then couldn't find anyone else.
Cliff Beasley was one of those on the tackle along with Cliff Thorpe. Here's Betanzas trying a 40-yard field goal. It's on the way. It is wide to the right and no good. He's missed from the near hash mark twice in the game. We have 10:04 left to go in the game, and the score remains the same, 27-23 LSU. Doug?
John, these are very difficult drives for LSU because they have driven a good distance and come away empty so often in this ball game, allowing Arizona to stay in. Arizona's only 4 points down, and with their great kicking games in Dejas, if he can peck away 3 points here and 3 points there, they're just not far away. A touchdown certainly puts them ahead, but two field goals also put them ahead, and they're well capable of that.
That was a 66-yard drive and no points. And here's a completed forward pass for a first down. Reuben Berry, number 3, is the pass catcher. And he's downed by the Tigers at the Arizona 34-yard line by Jeffrey Dale.
Reuben Berry is the young man that they'll count on to run a lot of reverses, to try to get the ball in his hands in the open field, because he has great quickness. He's the quickest of their wide receivers.
And two fine receivers, Dobbins and Horton, are wide out to the right this time. And here's a handoff up the middle to Vance Johnson. Cracking tackle right up the middle by the Tigers there. James Pearson, right cornerback of the game now, makes the stop. Head on, too. Second down, 9.
History shows you that Bill Osborne did a lot of work this past offseason. He's recruited a lot of fine freshmen that are playing right now for LSU.
Again, those two adept receivers are to the right of the formation, and here's a shotgun with Jenkins back, and they're moving down the field, and here's a pass underneath to Freeman at the 40, being chased at the 42, and down he goes, short of a first down. Kevin Guidry making the stop.
Here you're going to see it. This ball's just going to be thrown short, but watch when you see this, how wide open the field is. If one thing this Arizona offense does is makes you cover the entire football field, and that allows anytime there's a seam where someone gets the ball in it who has enough speed, he can go all the way. That's why it's so exciting to watch them. That's why it's so difficult to defend, because you've got to go sideline to sideline as a defensive secondary.
Tigers are not out of the woods yet. Ahead by 4. Third down and 2 for Arizona. The fake to the tailback and a pass. It's incomplete. Broken up by Hobley, intended for the tight end Gary Parrish, but knocked away. A good defensive play by Lippert Hobley.
Fine defensive play, but watch Sean Burks and Toby Caston come in there. They just completely annihilated the quarterback on that play. And I guarantee the next time he drops back and sees a blitz, he'll think about that last one.
And so a punt coming up by Lawton. Down the field, we have Jefferson of LSU at the 19. Good snap and no big rush of the kicker, and an end-over-ender going to Jefferson at the 19. Well, he almost got away with it. He gets short yardage on the return. It's a 38-yard kick. The clock shows 8:08 to play. LSU 27, Arizona 23. The Tigers have been down there a number of times, but came away with no points. The last time, a 66-yard drive. And prior to that, a 41-yard drive. You expect that the Tigers would really want to get those points when they get that kind of an effort going. From the 23. Running play up the middle is going to carry the Tigers to about the 25. That's Hilliard.
The real success LSU seems to have had this entire ball game, Bert, is when they're doing things in unusual situations. For example, the halfback pass on first down a few minutes ago. Whenever they've gotten into kind of a regimented offense where you run on first down and throw on third down, Arizona stopped them pretty well.
Yeah, Arizona has a good defense. I mean, they've only given up a little less than 50 yards on the rush, even though LSU's gotten much more than that on this game. But
here's Dalton Hilliard, and the flag hits the turf as he travels up for an apparent first down with Alan Durden. That flag hit the turf about where Craig Grafton was executing a block, and we may have a clip here, and Nunley is indicating that the penalty will be against LSU, and here's Mr. Burleson clipping against the Tigers. That one will hurt.
Yeah, we're going to see this. Craig Rathjen is going to be leading this play, and this is just a pitch.
Now, if this is called the clip, I don't know that when someone turns his back to you and you go to block him, that's not a clip. I don't know that that is the person they called it on. There also was a flanker on the outside, and perhaps the flag was thrown on him. Makes no difference because the penalty is there. LSU's pushed back inside of the 15, and what turned out to be a big gain for the first down ends up putting them back in the hole with a long, long way to go.
Second down, 18 to go. The Tigers are backed up to their 15. And the ominous presence of that Max Zendejas is over the atmosphere here. He's wide to the right, and for about an 8-yard gain goes Dalton Hilliard. As we look at Bill Arnsparker, Bunch makes the stop over there. I keep thinking about Max Zendejas. He really has a great leg, and he'd not like to have the game's outcome riding on whether he would make a field goal from almost any distance.
That's true, but he has one thing fighting against him, and the wind is in his face in this fourth quarter. And looking at the flags, they're standing up. It's a pretty good wind.
Injured earlier, Eric Endelsack is on the field and playing again. Wickersham pumps once. He's going to be trapped back there inside the 15. Another sack by the hard-charging forward wall of the Arizona Wildcats, and that brings up fourth down and a long way to go for LSU. As Parker comes on, Craig Vesling leads the Wildcats with Boomer Gibson.
Here you'll see Jeff just getting in trouble on the blitz. Not his fault. Uncovered people coming in his face. When you're backed up like that, once again, you have to chew on it sometimes.
Minus 8 on this possession. Back to the 15-yard line. Parker to kick. Has a lot of time. Kicks one. That's coming up high. David Adams at the 45. 48. And down he goes. Carrier, the center, was down quickly, as was Walden Cager. Numbers 11 and 6. 41 yards. A good kick there for Clay Parker. But the Wildcats again have great field position. And the Tigers have a 4-point lead, 27-23.
And the dangerous thing, John, is with 6 minutes left in this ball game, if LSU continues to give good field position, that fellow right there may enlarge that 12 completion to something a little bit more significant.
Jenkins takes the snap and retreats the throw. They're chasing him, but he rifles it way out away from Jay Dobbins, number 82. Jenkins, a sophomore from Linwood, California, weighs 225, stands 6'4". A strong fellow. Second down, 10. The Wildcats are at their 48 with 5:54 left to go in the game. Next week, Arizona plays Long Beach. LSU plays at Southern California. A Saturday afternoon game. Second down and 10. From the shotgun, Jenkins. That's Dobbins. Out of bounds inside the Tiger 35-yard line at the 33. Crossing right through the middle underneath the deep coverage. He gets 19 yards. And let's look at it again.
On this play, LSU's coming out with a blitz. What happens when you blitz is you leave people like this on people like Michael Brooks, a linebacker against a wide receiver, and that is a mismatch. Even though Michael's a tremendous player, wide receivers should always outrun a linebacker.
Martin and Reuben Berry are way out to the right as Jenkins is up under the center for this snap. First down at the LSU 33, draw play with Freeman. He's hit by Michael Brooks, and how did Brooks get in there? He lost his headgear in the process, but he was really a charger in there. Wilson also in on the tackle. Here comes Brooks to replace part of his headgear, replaced by Buddy Lewis. The gain is for one, and it's second down 9 at the LSU 32. An infrequently set eye formation. Barnett, the up back, and the pitch fake, and a pass down the middle, incomplete. Intended for Glenn Howell. Big 253-pound tight end, but the pass was thrown a little behind it.
And Howell is the best blocker of the tight ends, and consequently, he's the one that doesn't get the ball thrown to him very much. And I think it's evidenced by what you see right here. Howell was open. The ball was thrown there. He had it in his hands and just rocked it. That would have been a tremendous completion for Arizona. He would have been down to the 15-yard line with a big, big first down.
Third down, 9 at the LSU 32. The Wildcats pumping it down by 4 with 5 minutes to play. Jenkins again being chased. He'll have to hurry. He throws it. Man in the open. That's Johnson to the far side. He's out of bounds. Maybe gets the first down down to the 12, to the 22. Boy, can he go. He can really travel after he catches the football. But Jenkins, under a heavy rush, was lucky to get that one away. Big Tommy Clapp was coming in there to get him. And he just eluded everybody. And there was Johnson. First down, the Wildcats at the LSU 22. 4:51 to play in the game. 27-24, LSU ahead precariously by 4. And Johnson breaks to the 19. Henry Thomas makes the stop. I think the Tigers go to California next Thursday evening. And we hope to be greeting you from there sometime in the early afternoon, 1 week from today. Second down at the 20. Arizona. Pitch out to Adams. Adams is going to be hit. He reverses field. And they're going to get him behind the line. Good tackle over there by Norman Jefferson. Back at about the 23-yard line. We'll see Jeffrey Dale with some good pressure here.
And you see that, and there's the excellent play that makes him turn around and go the other way. And watch Michael Brooks here take his shot at Alfred Jenkins, who comes over to block it. Jenkins made a pretty good block there, but the entire LSU defense, with excellent pursuit on the backside, went over to tackle Alfred.
Third down and 11 for Arizona at the LSU 23. Arizona employs the shotgun. Jenkins has the ball. Not a first down, but a pass completion. Burks tackles Dobbin at about the 17. So that may bring on Max Zendejas for a try for 3. Here's the play again.
Jenkins dropping back. Dobbin's over the middle. He seems to always know where the first down mark is, but he's a little short on this one.
It's going to be a 34-yard field goal try straight away at the south end by Zendejas. If good, it will pull the Wildcats to within 1 with 3:02 to play in the game. Lawton is the holder. 34-yarders on the way, and it is good. And so with timeout and 2:52 to play in the game, the score is now LSU 27, Arizona 26.
Investment number 2. There was something missing in our community, but that's in the past. Now the Emergency Medical Service has answered over 17,000 calls for help. Half of those from our senior citizens. An investment in life. An investment Path Screen has made.
EMS has saved hundreds of lives. I don't know how we got along with ours for so long, but I do know how we got it. Path Screen.
Path Screen. Effectiveness today, leadership for our future.
Now the Wildcats have employed the strategy which they wanted to employ to get within a situation in which a field goal would win the game for them. LSU's offense has been inept for some time. That gives a lot of credit to Arizona's offense. Defense it is.
We're looking for an onside kick here.
Onside kick right here with Arizona looking to the other side. Going to do it though, and the kick is going to the end zone, and LSU will put it in play at the 20.
Well, certainly LSU had to be prepared for the onside kick, but from Arizona's standpoint, they've got 3 timeouts left in this game, 2:52 remaining, and they have been very successful holding LSU deep in the Tigers' own territory. And essentially what they've done is give it to LSU on the 20 and say, here, do what you want. We know that you don't feel comfortable throwing it. LSU 390-yard total offense, but in the last several series, they have not accumulated very much of that total.
From the 20, here go the Tigers with Hilliard bumping to the right side for about 5 yards. first half, LSU had 270 yards, 17 yards total offense. And here in the second half so far, it's about 180. Hilliard has gained 136 yards. Second down, 5. The Tigers are at their own 25 and needing to get out of their own territory for a change. Here comes Hilliard. He may do it here. First down. 2:10 to play in this game as Lyndon Brown applies the muscle on the tackle. The Tigers are really having to battle here, and the defense for Arizona has been just a little short of superlative here in the third and fourth quarters.
That was an extremely big first down because with the clock now down to 2 minutes, LSU is going to have about 15 more seconds to get this playoff, and they've got four downs in the series even if they don't make another first down.
1:50 to play in the game. LSU clings to a one-point lead. And here is Hilliard. Now that's Gary James being stopped almost at the line of scrimmage. Remember, you allowed 25 seconds between plays, and let's see if a timeout is going to be called. It will be called by Arizona. Timeout of the game. The score is LSU 27, Arizona 26.
V.J. Gentiloni Jr., an honest leader with proven mature experience, a full-time councilman for District 12. V.J. knows city parish government. As a department head, he worked with our council members, gaining unique insight into our government and its workings. V.J. also knows we need a full-time councilman. He will work for us. He will bring his mobile office to our neighborhoods each week. He will be that full-time councilman we need. District 12 needs V.J. Gentiloni Jr., a full-time councilman working for us.
Back to play, second down, about 9. The Tigers are at their 31 with Hilliard carrying the mail. Past the 35 to about the 36-yard line. The Tigers really want to exercise ball control here if possible. Joe Drake making the stop here on Hilliard. He's had a full night. And Matt DeFrank is practicing over here on the near side. We have 1:30 to play in this game. Arizona's used another timeout. And the Wildcats have one remaining. LSU has three.
John, I tell you, they started a long time ago, and it's all really come down to this play. If LSU makes this first down, they're going to be able to run the clock out, and that's going to be it, assuming they don't just fumble the snap from center. If they don't make the first down, Arizona, with one timeout left, will force LSU to punt and will, in all probability, have the ball in good enough field position, at least for Zendejas to have a shot before the ball game's over.
It's third down and 4, and the biggest play of the game is going to be played right now. LSU has the ball at its 36. Third down and 4, a possession down, and one of the largest ones you can think about in the game. And a quarterback draw is called. Wickersham is to the left. He's going to be thrown for a loss back to the 32. And the defense for Arizona comes to equal the task. And so the Tigers don't do what they wanted to do and have to give up the ball from their 32-yard line. Timeout called by the officials. Let's see what's going to happen here.
And here you see it. Eric Martin was lined up on the right, and Jeff Wickersham had him go down about 5 yards and just stop, and he was going to drop the ball to him. Arizona had him covered. They weren't going to back off that coverage. They were going to stay right there and make him beat him deep if he was going to beat him at all. Certainly expecting LSU not to go deep. Wickersham couldn't throw it, had to pull it down, sack.
The timeout is called and charged against Arizona. That's 6 sacks in the game for Arizona, totaling 42 yards. But the big thing is that Arizona's strategy does work for the Wildcats. And now the Tigers will have to give up the ball with a minute, 11 seconds left to play in the game. Down the field to receive David Adams. And Clay Parker is the punter for the Tigers. The point of the down is the LSU 32-yard line. The LSU Tigers lead by 1 point, 27-26. And omnipresent over this stadium is the right kicking foot of Max Zendejas. He can really boost the field goals.
John, let's not overlook what's going to happen before that. You know, Arizona has, on several occasions, brought 10 people, and they got 10 up there right now. Whether they'll bring them all or not, but they partially blocked one of Parker's earlier kicks.
Carrier gets the snap back. They rush him, and he kicks it away. It's not an especially long kick, but it's going to bounce inside the 35 and is touched there by the LSU Tigers, and Rob Cuthbert touches that 36-yard kick, and so the Wildcats will have the football first and 10 at their 32-yard line.
Let's see how the rush comes in here on Clay. Good snap. Gets the ball up. Let's see if he's still in the air. Oh, my goodness.
1:10 to go in the game, and now the big play offense of Arizona will put the Tiger defensive unit to the test. The Tigers lead by 1 point, and here is Jenkins to throw. The pass is blocked by Michael Brooks. A big play, 2nd and 10. The clock is stopped with 1:06 to play in the game.
On this play, Jenkins is back in the shotgun. The back is blocking Michael Brooks on a blitz, and Jenkins decides to go to him after he releases. Michael sees him coming, jumps up in the air, and makes a fine play.
2nd down and 10 yards to go. The Wildcats operating from their 32 and down by 1. With a great field goal artist on the sidelines waiting to come in, depending on field position. The shotgun. Jenkins with the ball to throw. He's going to throw. He does out there to Adams, who has it to the 45. He's running out of bounds at midfield, and that's where the Arizona Wildcats will put the ball in play with 56 seconds left. 17 yards for him on that, and that scat back David Adams really does go, and the Tiger is expressing some disconsolate feelings about all of this.
Now, John, you see Arizona's obvious intentions here to throw the ball underneath, try to get it to those running backs, let them go as far as they can, and then get out of bounds. And LSU, of course, has got to stop that.
The Bayhawks has kicked 3 field goals in this game. And Jenkins is back to throw on first down. He's hit as he throws. It's going to be incomplete. Way down there to John Horton, who got inside Kevin Guidry. That Horton scares me as much as Zendejas does.
Well, I tell you, you know, it's interesting to watch the cat and mouse, because on one play, if you figure they're going to throw it underneath, so you're going to keep all of your people up there to stop that play, bam, they try to go a little bit deep, and if the pass was a little bit better thrown that time, he's open enough to make the catch.
Larry Smith has a lot of big guns in his arsenal. 50 seconds left to go in the game. 2nd down and 10 at midfield for Arizona. The shotgun, the Tigers are ready, and here is Jenkins to throw out here. It's going to be incomplete. Good defensive play by the Tiger defender, Kevin Guidry, in his 3rd and 10.
Kevin Guidry on that play, a young freshman coming up with a critical play here. He's right on him all the way. Makes a hit at the right time, stripping him of any chance to catch the ball. Now it's 3rd and 10, and Arizona's play of the game.
Arizona, a big possession down. This is another big one right here. The shotgun. Alfred Jenkins has the football to throw. He does. It is complete. Not for a first down, but Dobbins rolls with it at the LSU 43-yard line in front of Ricky Chapman.
And the clock is still rolling here. 33, 32, 31 seconds left. They're going to have to get on the move because they...
No more timeouts for Arizona. 26 seconds left to go in the game. 4th down and 3. And if the Tigers stop Arizona from the first down here, it's all over. Here is Jenkins back to throw. He'll get the first down. He's not going to get it. He fumbles. The Tigers will have the football at their 41. And it'll be 1st down and 10 to go for the Tigers. And LSU will win this game. Jenkins coughs it up. Burks, it appears, yards the ball away from the talented Arizona quarterback. The Tigers are jubilant.
And John, that was just exceptional defensive effort, because Jenkins had broken up in the middle of the pocket and looked, as you said, like he was going to be able to easily go for the first down. Norman Jefferson there as happy as can be, because that series, of course, a tremendous series for LSU's defense.
And I think that he recovered the fumble on the far side just in front of the Larry Smith-led Arizona Wildcats, and the Tigers are going to run it out. 9 seconds left to go in the game, and this will be it as Wickersham is going down to a knee, and the clock is going to run out, and you'll listen to the crowd to signal the victory for the LSU Tigers. been a good battle, and as has been written, the Tigers win this one by the hair on their chinny-chin-chin. And it's a one-point victory for the LSU Fighting Tigers over Arizona. And we'll summarize tonight's exciting game in just a minute. There's your final, the Tigers 27, the Wildcats 26.
Your 98 WAFB Loves Me rear window sticker means cash. Put a 98 WAFB Loves Me rear window sticker on your car or truck and listen to FM 98. When you hear us call your license tag number, call us, and we'll pay your next car note or give you $200 in cash. And you might even win a brand new 1985 Toyota Corolla sedan. Remember, the longer you listen, the better your chance to win. Be a winner. Stick with 98 WAFB Radio.
Had 401 yards total offense in the game. Arizona 291. And very briefly, Betances kicked two field goals and missed two. And Vendejas of Arizona kicked three. Durden ran back an interception, 96 yards for touchdown. Hobley intercepted for LSU, ran back 36, and Hilliard scored right after that. In the first part of the game, it was a 10-3 game after that interception and field goal by Arizona and Betances' field goal. LSU had James scoring a touchdown at the end of a 70-yard drive, and Jenkins passed to Johnson at the end of a 41-yard pass play and a long travel down the field. And then a 20-yard pass play, Wickersham to Fontenot brought the Tigers seven more with the point after. And then Zendejas kicked his final two field goals in the fourth quarter, when really Arizona had the better of the going, and the final count was LSU 27 and Arizona 26, as Zendejas never got in position to try the final and maybe telling field goal. The Tigers win a squeaker by 1 point.
John, we were waiting to see if Zendejas was going to have an opportunity, but this is the play that broke it up. That's Michael Brooks came up, made the big hit on Jenkins just when it looked like Jenkins was going to make the first down. That deprived them of the first down and certainly the opportunity for Zendejas to make any kind of a kick.
Time and time again, Michael Brooks seems to come up with a big play. He did earlier in the half, he did in the first half, and there on the last play of the game for Arizona, he came up with the play of the game.
You know, guys, freshmen, some of them can play football still, huh?
A lot of them can. I never knew one very well, you know, in my age bracket that could play much ball.
What did you think about the way that Arizona tried to attack LSU with this offense?
I think it's kind of helter-skelter, so to speak. I don't think that they'll ever consistently do good that way because they're not trying to. They're just trying to throw it up, get the big play as you can. I think that you'll see LSU play a more established type offense as well as defense, which constitutes the fact that they'll be successful day in and day out a little more so. Arizona thrives and lives strictly on the big play, whereas LSU tries to be a little more methodical in these big plays and get them as they come as opposed to try to get them each time they go out.
Tigers against Southern Cal next week. Now, Jeff Wickersham's got to improve a little bit and not throw the bad passes, be able to execute that offense a little bit better, don't you think?
I think Jeff will. I think he's an excellent talent. I think going out to SC, as you saw him go to Florida and do the good things against a high-pressure game, against a good team going home, now he's going to SC, Los Angeles, Tinseltown, and everything. I think he'll do a fine job.
And so next week at home, Arizona entertains Long Beach State, and LSU will be at the University of Southern California. It'll be a Saturday afternoon game, and it will be a huge test for the LSU Tigers.
Without question. We haven't played SC too much in the past. When we did, we lost it right at the end. This year, it's going to be a big test for them because SC is bouncing back, and we're playing them out there. And I played in the Coliseum, Doug, and it's a tough place to play.
And Southern Cal looks like they're a team that has come back. Had a very bad year last year, but has started out strongly this year, has a world of ability, and, of course, so many football players in California, it's tough to compete with them.
And the final here again tonight, the LSU Fighting Tigers 27, Arizona 26. The Tigers now have won two games, no losses, and a tie for the 1984 record. This is John Ferguson with Bert Jones and Doug Morrow. Thank you, and good night from Tiger Stadium.